we're back here once again giving you this truth pursuant to the Most High. How about you? How about you? Shabbat Shalom, Kaddish. Hope you can hear me good. You see, in front of you, you see two of the apostles. I'm off to the side. I got the desktop. But anyway, we're just going to go right into it. Oh, we didn't go out today because early this morning it was bitterly cold. That's what they were saying. So I said, well, we'll take a break. But then I went outside. I said, it was worse last week. It was way far cold last week because it was windy. But then I was going to call and say, nah, we're going to go out anyway. But then I said, you know what? This is a change of pace.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep.
And Most High willing will be out there next week, you know?
Yep.
So anyway, we're going to go right into it. I wanted to go into, as we've been going into prophecies, you know, we'll cover the word prophecy. What does it mean? We might go into the Bible dictionary, the Bible encyclopedia, whatever.
Real studious lesson.
Well, we'll see, you know. Yeah. But I wanted to start off with 2nd Ezra, the 4th chapter. We're going to start from the first verse. And I was listening to it. I'm familiar with that chapter, but I was listening to it coming back. And I said, yeah, that's the perfect scripture to start with, you know, because it's dealing with the prophets. The most important men are the prophets of the Lord. Not the king, not the general, not the prince, not the priest, you know, but the prophet. The Most High is dealing directly with Israelites who are the prophets. And just because you find out that you're an Israelite doesn't mean that you're a prophet. You got a lot of guys, they find out that women, they find out they're Israelites, but then they say, oh, I'm a prophet. I'm going to go out there. You know, maybe you're a helper, you know?
Yeah.
Maybe you just know that you're an Israelite. Because a lot of you guys are going off, you know? But a lot of y'all got it right, too.
I got a precept for you.
Go ahead.
The book of Hebrews 1:1. The Most High, who at sundry times and in diverse manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets. You say about how important the prophets are?
Yeah, because anything that happens as far as prophecy is concerned, the Most High uses the prophet to tell things that are going to happen in the future.
Yeah.
Oh, real quick, give me Isaiah 42:9, and I believe Isaiah 46:9-10.
Can I read this real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
This is the word prophet. It says, an authoritative person who divines the future.
Yeah, you did that. I couldn't have said it better myself. Read that again, please.
It says, an authoritative person who divines the future.
Yeah, so what does a prophet do? They tell you of things to come.
Right.
I want to explain a precept for you.
Go ahead.
The book of Numbers 12:6. And he said, well, let me start at 5. And the Lord came down in the pillar of the cloud and stood in the door of the tabernacle and called Aaron and Miriam. And they both came forth, and he said, hear now my words. If there be a prophet among you, I, the Lord, will make myself known unto him in a vision and will speak unto him in a dream.
Will you read that?
The book of Numbers 12:5-6.
Yeah, that's Moses. Matter of fact, you can read more of that. Go into it.
Matter of fact,
start from the top.
Okay.
So it could go, so you can get more into the context. Because basically, what happened was Miriam, the older sister of both Moses and Aaron, was talking shit, pop styling, to Moses.
Yep.
And you know, Moses was a humble man.
Yep.
You know, people, when they picture a prophet, they picture him as a say, like a, he won the Mr. Olympia contest.
Yeah.
He got that growl, you know,
yeah.
Laser beams come out of his eye.
Yeah.
Them prophets were. The prophets, they were ordinary men.
Yeah.
Yeah. Jeremiah, which whole Jeremiah 1:4, Jeremiah was a boy. When he said he was young, he wasn't like a teen, he was a boy.
Yeah.
He had to be maybe 11, 10 years old.
Yeah.
The youngest king in Israel was 5 years old.
Mm.
So, you know, you look at, brothers, man.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Hey, you got the, you know, holding the laws with a single bicep and all that.
That's that Hollywood stuff, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Like Prometheus.
Exactly. Yep.
So, well, we kind of told you, brother, stop with that.
Oh, they did.
The knee-hanging look.
Yeah. But that's how you want to. That's how you want to perceive the men of the Lord.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah. Anyway, go ahead.
All that heavenly glory.
That's it.
Numbers 12 and 1, it says...
We ain't got our glorious bodies yet.
That's true.
Far from it.
Numbers 12 and 1, it says, and Miriam and Aaron spake again against Moses because of the Ethiopian woman.
Yeah, because why did they speak against him? Because he was dealing with a woman of another nation. But why was he dealing with a woman of another nation? Really, the Most High set it up, but really, so he can... getting close with Miriam's father, which was Jethro.
Right.
Yeah.
And Jethro was a tribesman. He knew how to set order. Yeah. Moses didn't know how to set order. As you read the scriptures, it said that Jethro spoke to him and he said, What do you do, you know, with the people? He said, I just sit there all day and they come one by one with their problems and I show them the law.
Yeah.
And then Jethro told him, he said, no, that's not good. He said, You will be worn out and your people will be worn out.
Yeah.
He says, set among you men of honest report to be officers of 10, officers of 50, officers of 100, officers of 1,000, whatever. And then the small matters, they deal with them, and the big matters, you deal with them. And what is a big matter?
Adultery.
Well, no. What is a big matter? Big matter is a small matter that got out of the matter. Every big issue starts with a small issue.
Right.
That's how wars, the World War One, World War Two, it was always one incident. What was World War One? One of these dignitaries got killed.
Austrian prince
got killed, yeah. And it turned into a war. And how many people died? Hundreds of thousands of people.
Yeah.
Yeah, you brought that point out in your Daniel 11 video.
Mm.
You spoke about Bernice.
Bernice. Bernice and Laodicea. There was people that was killed by that, you know?
Yeah.
So a big problem is something that is a small problem that gets out of hand, but you don't get it. So you other leaders and GMS, we don't got to be calling to find out what's going on. That's where order comes in.
Right.
You know, if it's a big problem, this guy did this and he's been going off, he hasn't been coming.
Yeah.
So it comes up to us and then we say, well, look, if he can't get his act together, he got to leave, he got to get suspended.
You know? You got heads, you got regional heads, you know, where brothers can deal with, you know.
Another good example is go to Acts 6.
Oh, God. This is the book of Acts.
So you got Nate or Bishop, let me say it correctly.
Oh, yeah.
So nobody get mad.
Yeah.
The high exalted grand poobah, Nathaniel.
Then
is great.
Yep.
He goes all over the place. He doesn't have to go all over the place. You got men that are in different regions, you know, that can deal with, you know.
This is Numbers chapter 6, verse 1. I'm sorry, Acts chapter 6, verse 1. And in those days, when the number of the disciples was multiplied, there arose a murmuring of the Grecians against the Hebrews.
Yeah, for you Israelites that don't understand the difference between the word Greek and Grecian, or Gentiles, or Cornelius, you see this. And you'll say, yeah, well, those are talking about other nations. No, they ain't talking about other nations. They're talking about Israelites that was outside of Israel that didn't speak the Hebrew language. You know, when you read about the Pentecost, all those different Israelites coming from all over those different regions were all Israelites, man. They didn't know the proper Hebrew. They knew maybe a few words. They knew how to probably read the Torah. But they were speaking the languages that they were born in. And that's a big controversy with these Christians, like vocab. But well, wait a minute, so the Gentile. And you know what? You know, going to these theological seminaries, the Most High did, there's no scripture where it said the Most High gave this word to a bunch of white people that built up a goddamn school. You know? So you don't have the truth. And go ahead.
It says, because their widows were neglected in the daily ministration.
And what is the administration? Because they made an agreement. There were some that were rich. There were some that were in the middle, and some that were poor. And they had lands, and you had a lot of disciples that were rich. And they said, we're going to bring it all together. If you need this, you get this. You need that, you get that. So they were like putting the widows to the side, because they didn't really look at them as real Israelites. Well, first of all, your son didn't get circumcised until they were 19. All this other nonsense, man. So the apostles had to do something about it. Go ahead.
It says, then the 12 called the multitude of the disciples unto them and said, it is no reason that we should leave the word of the Most High and serve tables.
So what did that mean? Pretty much what Moses was doing. He was serving tables. He was dealing with each and every Israelite situation.
Right.
So Josh, what's his name?
Peter.
No. I'm talking about his father-in-law. Jeff will have to straighten him out instead. You know, set up men to be over tens and thousands and hundreds and fifties. You know. Go ahead.
It says, wherefore, brethren, look ye out among yourselves, men of honest report, full of the Holy Spirit and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business.
And what does it mean, full of wisdom? Meaning this man is a man of a particular age that has life experience, plus he has the Holy Spirit in him, plus he's of honest report. And Stephen was one of them.
Right.
Yeah. Go ahead.
But we will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word.
And what's the prayer and ministry of the word? What we're doing right now. What do we do? We teach.
Yeah.
We teach.
Come. Yeah. Minister the word.
That's it. Go ahead.
It says, and the same pleased the whole multitude, and they chose Stephen, a man full of faith, and the Holy Spirit, and Philip, and Prochorus, and Nicanor, and Timon, and Parmenas, and Nicholas, a proselyte of Antioch.
Oh, what's a proselyte? A proselyte is one that's a part of one faith that comes into another faith, newly in the faith. And you notice these individuals had Greek-sounding names.
Yeah, I was just thinking
of
that.
Those were Israelites. But they were living in different, they were born in different regions of the world.
Yep.
No doubt they spoke Greek.
Exactly. All right, that's it. That's all we need.
Back to Numbers.
Yeah.
Numbers 12 and 2. It says, and they said, have the Lord indeed spoken only by Moses? Have he not spoken also by us? And the Lord heard it. Now.
And so that's what a lot of these other camps do. You know, like we've been getting on bow, you know, be a believer of the way. And they're like, look, the Most High is dealing with us too. When we say it, no. The Most High established us. Because we've been in this thing before you've been in this thing.
That's right.
You know, and you know us by our very work's sake.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. And none of you would ever know anything if it wasn't for the One West camps through the Spirit. Putting out this word, but now all of a sudden you're the experts and telling everybody how it's broken down when you didn't have a clue of what the Bible meant prior to watching YouTube videos.
Well, this guy, the head guy, so to speak, he said that he came up under guys that were taught by Ariana that actually came to New York, but then he cursed me out saying, see, the Lord had a dream that world to the year 2000 and never had no dream. That was a doctrine.
Right.
All right. And furthermore, the guys that taught you, that you said got it from Ariala, all right, which I knew him personally, man.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
They had to be teaching the same thing. So why would they come to New York? I'm pretty sure they heard it.
Yeah.
So, you know, stop playing, man. You're just not a man of the Lord.
That's it.
You're just an Israelite, man.
That's it.
Humble yourself.
Go ahead.
Back in Numbers 12. Third verse.
Now, and you can, by the way, you can, well, that's a topic right there. You can learn this truth by way of the internet.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's a topic in itself.
Mm-hmm.
All right, guys just said, well, you don't have the truth because you, well, wait a minute, truth is truth.
Right.
Yeah.
If I teach you that one and one is two on the internet, oh, that really don't mean that because you heard it on the internet. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, back in the day, you had individuals that learned the truth off the cable shows.
Mm-hmm.
What about that?
Yeah.
That wasn't the school.
When Apostle Paul set up those different churches, he would send letters, and there would be people that read the letters that never met the Apostle Paul and believed. Yeah. And the scriptures speak about them hearing about the fame of the Lord and different things, you know?
Yeah, so instead of us sending letters back and forth, we put on the videos. We do video epistles.
Yeah.
So can you grow and become a teacher, you know, a prophet from watching a video? Of course you can.
Yeah. Hey, well, the prophets, the Lord showed them videos, those visions that they saw.
Those are divine videos.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, all those different camps across America, yeah, they got together.
No, all those guys were false guys. They're just going to disappear in a puff of smoke.
Some of them guys gave up their jobs, gave up their lives for what they heard over the internet.
And while you arrived at was talking, what have you been doing?
Exactly.
What corners have you been on?
Exactly.
None.
Who have you edified?
None. Nobody.
You like that fig tree that...
Well, comfy's like that fig tree.
Yeah.
Comfy. That's why the Most High took him out and made him wither away. Unless he's in Dubai with Michael Jackson and
hanging out.
Epstein.
Yep.
And Prince. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, there's a story of the fig tree with Yahweh Shai came to it. And scriptures say that he was hungry and there was no figs on that tree and he got mad. He cursed that tree and it died right. As soon as he said the words, the tree just.
Yeah, with it.
Because
it would never grow again.
Never grow
again. And see, when Comfy was doing his thing, he was doing him.
Yeah.
He was doing him, man.
Serving his own belly.
He was serving his own belly.
Yeah. And the scriptures say that the disciples, they marveled at how the tree just died like that. Because you remember, they were coming up with Yahweh Shai. They didn't know the full power of that. So when they saw that, they said, oh, shit. To put it in modern day terms.
Yeah. Well, that goes with the scripture about being lukewarm. Either cold or hot.
Yep. You had something?
Yeah, I got something real quick. This is Romans chapter 10, verse 19. It says, but I say, did not Israel know? I'm sorry, that's not it. Verse 18. But I say, have they not heard? Yes, verily, their word, I'm sorry, their sound went into all the earth and unto, I'm sorry, and their words unto the ends of the world. And how did that happen? By the internet. You know?
Yeah, it can't happen any other way. There's no way in hell we can go to every city, you know, every town and teach. Matter of fact, that's in Matthew 10.
Yep.
I'm going to start at the 20th verse.
I get it.
Okay.
Yeah, Matthew.
Yeah, then you got, you know, you have scriptures in the Bible that speak about, but scriptures say that knowledge shall increase.
Yeah,
you know?
I got this.
You know, what made this thing worldwide?
The web.
The web is the thing that made this thing worldwide. It said make full proof of thy ministry. And you at the ICGJC is not making full proof of your ministry. Well, they ain't putting up videos. The only people that can learn that go to your schools or your churches.
Yeah. You don't even hear them about them anywhere.
Yeah, Matthew 10 and 20. It says, let me start at 19. But when they deliver you up, take no thought how or what you shall speak, for it shall be given you in the same hour what you shall speak. For it is not you that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you.
What verse you mean?
Yeah, 19. 9 and 21. Is that the one you want?
Yeah, Matthew 10, verse 20.
Yeah. Matthew 10 and 20. For it is not you that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you, and the brother shall deliver up the brother to death, and the father the child, and the children shall rise up against their parents and cause them to be put to death. And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, but he that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. But when they persecute you in this city...
What does it mean to he that endures to the end?
real to the end when the ministry is over. Basically, when Yahushua is coming to deliver.
Yeah, in other words, you got to keep teaching. In other words, this doesn't mean you're not enduring to the end if you know you're an Israelite. A lot of guys full of, they still know that you're Israelites. Yep. If they ain't doing the work, they ain't enduring to the end.
No.
You don't endure because you knew that you, because you know you're an Israelite, man.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Reading on, it says, but when they persecute you in this city, flee ye into another. Well, verily I say unto you, you shall.
Oh, like when this guy Bocat rolled up on us. What do? No more live streams, and we went someplace else, right?
Yeah, that's it. That's
so we're going by with the scriptures. We said, look, we're going to be out there next week. We're going to have Abiel with us. We have, in case anybody does
they,
something, we're going to
say
Abiel, the great intimidator. Because that was wicked with you,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, yeah.
And the Most High clearly is not dealing with you.
Yeah. Yeah. Calm.
The scriptures say, I'm going to throw some scriptures out.
Yeah.
Be wise as a serpent, harmless as a dove. When did Yahushua and the 12, or the disciples and the 5,000, okay, now we can roll up on the wicked scribe. Let's see what they're going to say now. Roll up on them.
Right.
And then the disciples were put to death. The 5,000 didn't say, well, let's go get, you know?
Yeah. Yeah,
the scriptures say, be wise as a serpent, harmless as a dove, man.
Yeah, that's right.
It says, be like sheep in the midst of wolves.
Yeah. Also says,
so it's obvious you guys don't have that spirit of the scriptures, man. You're doing your own thing.
Yeah, the Lord, Yahushua said he sent us as sheep among wolves. You guys are acting more like wolves than sheep.
Yeah.
Sheep are not intimidating.
Yeah, it was funny. I was watching the other night, Denzel, Training Day. I was kind of getting into it like I got the last 15 minutes, but they had the closing credits, and the first song they played was Y'all Police Better Be Ready. And then when the wolves come out, when the wolves come out, and
yeah, the wolves.
That's
M.O.P.
So I was thinking about that, and then I was thinking about Benjamin. Now, M.O.P., it could be Benjamin.
I think
that scripture is going to be fulfilled when this man goes down.
Yeah.
Not now.
Yeah.
Not now. You know.
Esau's night will be our morning.
Our morning, exactly. Why does the serpent harmless as a dove, man? Oh, give me. I believe it's Matthew 5:11. If I'm not mistaken, I know it's in Matthew 5.
Matthew 5:11. It says, "Blessed are ye when men shall revile you," that one?
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
"And persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you."
What about this Joy Morgan?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. The scripture said, "Blessed are you when they speak bad of you."
Yeah.
The scripture didn't say nothing, but make sure you roll up on them guys.
Right.
And I remember them two swords I told you about.
Yeah.
Use them.
Yeah.
Right. The Lord never said every once in a while, you got to kick a centurion's ass. You know, it's the Lord never said every once in a while you got to beat a wicked scribe and Pharisee down. You know?
Yeah.
So that shows that the Lord is clearly not dealing with them, man.
Yeah, you guys act more like thugs.
Well, that's what they used to call us.
Yeah.
They said we never roll up on nobody.
No, hell no.
You know?
Hell no.
And give me a Jeremiah. In Jeremiah 9:23.
Yeah, we're spiritual men. That's why. We're not carnal. Scripture say a carnal mind is enmity with the Heavenly Father.
Yeah, Romans 8:1. Yep.
You said Jeremiah 9:23.
Yeah, Jeremiah 9.
Oh, 9. No, right.
And see, he even got brothers in GMS with their avatars. You got the guy with them looking like Lee Haney and what's this guy?
Ronnie Coleman.
Ronnie Coleman. Look at Ronnie Coleman now. Man, I'll kick Ronnie Coleman's ass. That dude got to walk around with crutches.
Damn.
What about
wearing diapers, man.
Yeah, what about the Apostle Paul?
You ever see Ronnie Coleman, man? He's all crushed up, man. He's all, he got to, you know, he couldn't run down a damn roach.
Damn.
Well, Apostle Tara, he always told that story about that dude, Gad. When he first came to One West,
yeah, he was all built.
This dude
was all
chiseled.
He used to look at, he used to,
yeah,
you know, ice grill you and shit.
Yep.
And then the Most High zapped his ass, and I believe the Most High put it. When the Most High took his muscles, he became humble, man. He was like the humblest guy. You see, that muscles don't mean a damn thing, man. With the Most High.
That's it.
That's another topic.
Yeah,
but God, the muscles don't mean a damn thing.
And with the Most High, I said, he don't take pleasure in the legs of a man.
That's it.
He said, bring that speech out.
It just means a lot to Diana Ross. I want muscle.
Oh, she wants wigs.
Murray's wigs.
He goes,
I'm sorry. It's okay. Pull that up a little bit. Let it a little later.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah.
Jeremiah 9 and 23.
Be careful. Thing, be careful because it snaps like a gator.
Okay.
You gotta be gentle with it.
Bring it up a little bit more. There we go. Yeah.
Jeremiah 9 and 23, it says, thus saith the Lord, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom.
Now you got guys that come into this thing. And they have college degrees. You don't last, them guys don't last too long. You know, well, I went to theological. Please don't say you was from a theological seminary, man, because you ain't going to get this.
Yeah.
Most I'm not dealing with you, man. Nah. Vocab is still losing sleep over the ass whooping, spiritual ass whooping that we gave. And anytime you come back to New York, let us know. We'll tell you where we at so we can beat up on you some more and do the spirit.
Hey, Yahweh Shai told Nicodemus that you were a master in Israel. You don't know this simple thing the Lord told him. Mm-hmm. You have to be born again. So,
Jeremiah 9 and 23, thus saith the Lord, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom, neither let the mighty man glory in his might, let not the rich man glory in his riches, but let him, there it is right there. Let the mighty man glory in his might, let not the rich man glory in his riches, but let him that glorifieth glory in this, that he understandeth and knoweth me, that I am the Lord, which exercise loving kindness, judgment, and righteousness in the earth. For in these things I delight, saith the Lord.
And you know what you can get since you hit the part of the riches?
Yeah.
Let not them glory in the riches. Revelation 3 and 15 on down. Because a lot of guys then came into this thing, former Long Westers, and they were out there on the highways and the byways, and they came into money, and then you don't see them out there no more. Like Johanna. Johanna ain't out there no more. He ain't on fire. He's been lately coming up back in there because we've been cursing his ass out. He's an ability to have to start. He's controlling myself a little bit more. So, hey, brother, this money don't mean that it shouldn't mean a damn thing to you, man.
So he's the guy that fears, how'd that scripture go? He fears man, he doesn't fear the Most High. Roughly paraphrasing.
Yeah, that's in the Apocrypha. Like if you go to the Lord's eyes a thousand times brighter than the sun, right before that, that's what that precept is. You know? All right, go ahead.
Revelation 3 and 15. I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. But I would thou wert cold or hot. Now, when you go into the 14th verse, let me read the 14th verse. And unto the angel of the church of the Laodiceans write these things, saith the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation of the Heavenly Father, which would be our shine. I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I would thou wert cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth.
And that's why guys get kicked out of fall off. Why? Because they were lukewarm. That's what the Most High said.
Yep, now here's the point why Apostle Paul brought the scripture out, the 17th verse. Because thou sayest, now who's the thou? The church at Laodicea, right? Because thou sayest, I am rich and increase with goods and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked.
Yeah, destitute of the truth.
Yep. There's also a scripture where it speaks about It's in Timothy.
Yeah, 1 Timothy 6. Is it 1 Timothy?
Supposing that gain.
Yeah, go to this.
Yeah.
1 Timothy or 2 Timothy 6?
I'm not sure. Might be 1 Timothy 6.
We go to 1 Timothy 6.
You getting it?
Yeah, go
okay.
On. Yep, 1 Timothy 6. Wow.
A lot of meat.
Yeah.
You can start, you know what you can do? Start at about the 4th verse.
Okay.
See what that says. The whole chapter is good, but.
Can I start at 3?
You go ahead.
All right, verse 3, it says, if any man teach otherwise and consent not to wholesome words, even the words of our Lord Yahushai, and to the doctrine which is according to godliness.
And the doctrine is what? The whole book.
Yep.
So if you're saying the mark of the beast is something other than what it really is, then you are not dealing with the whole book.
Nope.
The whole world. Doctrine, this, you know, these other things.
You
a lot of you guys got emotional. You're still emotional.
Yeah.
You still, hey, here, Brother Polite got it. He got it. He studied it. He got it. And yeah. You guys still ain't got it, man.
Yeah, there's a lot of emotional cats.
Yeah, a lot of emotional Israelites. Go ahead.
It says, he is proud, knowing nothing, but doting about questions and
stuff. What do you mean, doting about questions? He's questioning everything.
Yeah.
And like Sarnetta, I was watching Sarnetta with Lord Abba, and there they go. They were doting about questions. Who does the Lord does this? And what does it mean when he does this? And does he really? Like, Sarnetta knows that we have the truth.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why he always brings up videos with Israel on it. But he questions it. He's trying to, like you said in the video you did earlier, I was checking out. They question everything. They're looking for a loophole. They know it's the truth, but they're looking for a loophole out of it, you know?
Yeah, I was just looking up the word doting.
Okay, you got it.
Yeah, it says extremely and uncritically fond of someone, adored.
Yeah, in other words, they love to ask a lot of questions. They love to question a lot of things. Like you in love with a chick, right? And you don't think she's in love with you. And you say, well, why was you late? She got to explain herself, you know?
Right. This might be, it says here, archaic. Be silly or feeble-minded.
Well, that's what they're doing. They're being feeble-minded. They're asking all these questions, and you know the answers.
It says, especially as a result of old age.
Well, somebody getting up there in age.
I got the one, Timothy, the word.
Look, we know we have the truth. Well, let's have a debate. Why do I got to have a debate? I know I got the truth.
Right.
If I'm taking a trip somewhere with a map, and you're telling me I'm going the wrong way, I'm not going to listen to you.
Right.
Go ahead.
This is G3552, no sale. It says, to be sick. That is by implication of a diseased appetite, to hanker after, figuratively to harp upon, dope.
Yeah, that's what they're doing. They keep bringing up, well, what about this one?
Right.
Do you really believe that the Lord turned water into wine? Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah, I think you're going to get a different answer because they keep asking.
And somehow we're going to give you some scientific breakdown of how water could be turned to wine.
Right.
Now, I bet you Esau can do that shit. He can turn water into wine.
Yeah.
He can take plants and turn it into meat.
Yeah, with
possible meat.
That's a devil for you, man. As a matter of fact, go ahead, speak. I'm going to see if I'm going to put in the word question.
Now,
as can a white man turn
as you say
into
now,
wine?
As you say
now. That's what we're drinking, wine or water.
Yeah. As you say now, I was thinking about what the prophecy says about the so-called white man. He's wiser than Daniel. He says, there's no secret they can hide from me. So, you said that too, Apostle Tar, in one of your videos, the latest one. He said, don't think that the white man's a dummy. He's not a dummy. And I was listening to it, I was like, yeah, he's not. You know, the so-called white man, he's up on shit.
He's a smarty.
He's up on. Look, you go in Genesis, it speaks about the serpent was more subtile than any beast in the field. Who the hell do you think he's talking about?
Right.
He's talking about the so-called white man.
Yeah,
back to, yeah.
Sorry,
you got it.
No, the song that says they accomplish a diligent search.
Yeah, the man is not stupid.
Their heart is deep.
Yep.
They search things out. Wait, knowledge shall be increased.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So they've searched things out because they know that if they can search out the earth and the stars and the waters and all that,
they're trying to.
Then the Lord will do away with the nation of Israel.
Right. So they can't do it. It's impossible to do that. You know.
Because if that's the case, they would have to extinguish the sun, extinguish the moon, the stars, the constellations of the heavens.
Yep.
And they know it's impossible. You know. And although we know Jake messed up, the scriptures say that the Lord will still have mercy upon Jacob. Because that is the seed that the Lord chose.
Yep. No. And
check this out. I put in, can you turn water into wine? And yep, you can turn water into wine.
Mm-hmm.
And he breaks it down. He said water to wine. Treat one glass with about a teaspoon of fennel flocculant solution.
Yeah.
Pour some of the sodium carbonate treated water into the untreated glass.
Yeah.
Pour some of the sodium carbonate treated water into the pre-treated glass, and the solution will immediately turn red.
Yeah, so, that's why some people read that and say, see? What made Jesus, they'll say Jesus, we know it's Yahusha. They'll say, what?
Oh shit, you saw a picture's height? Well,
yeah.
Actually, can turn.
They'll say like.
Take water and turn it into wine. But hey,
yeah.
Esau.
Yeah.
You know?
They'll say like, see, what made Jesus so special? You know? Because you can do that, see?
Right. This is Psalm 64 and 6. It says, they search out iniquities, they accomplish a diligent search. Both the inward thought of every one of them and the heart is deep.
But you know what? Yahushua didn't just turn water into wine. That was some good-ass wine because the governor of the feast.
He's going to make good wine, too.
Not as good as Yahushua.
I don't know. I'm messing around.
Oh, man. Yahushua's wine.
Well, the point is, can you make water from wine? Esau can do it.
Yeah.
Hence, thou art wiser than Daniel.
Yeah.
So Esau got it, man.
You got it.
So that's why you Negroes, you can't bring Esau down. You can't bring him down.
Yeah, that's what it
is.
Because he's in his power seat. Not us, Lahab. Esau's in his power seat.
Yeah. Because that was some, like they say in the street, that was some hella wine. Because the governor of the feast said, man, usually we bring out the good stuff. Then when men are well drunk,
bring out
the bad stuff. And
that proves that they Negroes.
Yeah, he said, this wine, he probably was sipping it like, what kind of wine is that? Was Yahusha. That was Yahusha's wine.
Yep.
The bottle with Yahusha's wine on it.
This is some good ass wine.
But you know what that means? That's symbolic of the truth.
That's what the Lord said, I will meet you in the kingdom. We will drink wine in the kingdom.
Yeah.
He going to make that wine.
Yeah.
He going to do this and the wine is just going to
appear,
it's gonna float in heaven, man.
Hey, well, he prayed over the fish and the bread.
And the bread, yeah.
And he fed 4,000 at one time, 5,000.
And I bet you Esau could do that too. And if Esau could take a piece of grass and turn it into a steak.
Grass fed steak.
Yeah.
Well, I had when that thing Beyond Meat came out and tried it, man, it would taste just like fucking meat.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, it sure got good.
Same texture.
Yeah, he saw this is not with that, man.
Yeah, but that's the Most High on the left hand side feeding that.
That's it.
Feeding
that's
that
it.
Bastard.
But that'll give you cancer.
Oh, yeah.
That his meat will give you cancer.
That's that soil and green.
Soil and green.
Yep.
I still got a little more. This is back in 1 Timothy 6 and 4. He is proud, knowing nothing, but doting about questions and strifes of words. Whereof cometh envy, strife, railings, evil surmisings, perverse disputing of men of corrupt minds.
Yeah, because their minds are corrupt. They kind of know the truth, but they're questioning every little detail of what the truth is. And that's why a person that thinks that way cannot see prophecy.
Right.
They cannot see prophecy. Even Israelites. the number one prophecy is going to hit before the destruction. This destruction is not going to come until the microchip comes, the mark of the beast. Okay?
Yeah.
So if you're thinking that the Lord is going one day, you're walking down the street, you won't see the missiles coming? No, that ain't gonna happen, man. That's an operation. What is that? Blue Beam, man. That's Blue Beam.
Project Blue Beam.
You see a picture. You see the ship coming. Yeah. Then you see a Edomite.
Yeah.
And then you believe. Oh my goodness, I was wrong. I didn't know. You know.
Well,
that ain't going. The destruction is not gonna come until the chip comes first. All right.
That's it.
Esau is in the producing the chip through these other things. See, you guys don't know how the story goes, man.
Yeah.
They had to bring this shit out first before they can lay that chip on you, man.
Yeah. That's right.
That's why Rahm Emanuel, he said, never let a good crisis go to waste.
Yep.
They're gonna.
That's why this thing ain't never going away. Yeah. And this thing right here ain't never going away. You know why? They got there's deadliest strains coming out of England, seven times worse.
Yeah, you could play.
Well, if that was the case, wouldn't they just, everybody got locked down? Everybody go in your fucking house and stay there.
Yeah.
But then they got another one that's worse than the one from Great Britain,
right,
which is out of South Africa. It's 20 times dead, and it's already here in New York.
Right.
And you know what? People are looking. Well, you got the dummies riding down the road with the mask on, and only one in the car. And I'd be tempted to say, look, motherfucker, take that fucking, you know?
Yeah.
You gonna do, give it to yourself?
There was
my Jose's ex-wife, she got it, right? And my demon, you know, she got it. And then she showed me a picture, she was all, had all that shit on that. And I said, that's bullshit, you know?
Yeah.
I don't know, she might die. I said, that's bullshit. And then sure enough, they let her out. They said, we're gonna let you go. You just gotta stay in the house 14 days. So wait a minute, I thought this was like the
death.
Come on now, come on, son. Go ahead.
It says, perverse disputing of men of corrupt minds and destitute of the truth.
Yeah, destitute of the truth. They're questioning the truth, but they'll never get it because the Most High has not opened up their eyes to the truth.
That's it.
You get it because the Most High opened up your eyes. Perfect example I always go to, Numbers 24. Yeah. Abelam, and this guy wasn't an Israelite. It said, in a man whose eyes were open, what did Balaam see? And I love that story, man. I love that story. Balaam said in the 23rd chapter that he wished he can wake up and be like them.
Yeah.
Why? Because he saw morning, we're talking about somewhere around 3,500 years, he saw the mark of the beast. He saw the missiles. He saw Jake fucking up Esau. He saw the kingdom.
Yeah.
And this man was a heathen.
Yeah.
Wow.
I got a quick precept. Titus 1:15.
I'm going to have to bring that down. There's like a lot of glare.
Okay, go ahead. Bring it on down.
Titus 1:15, it says, unto the pure, all things are pure. But unto them which are defiled and unbelieving is nothing pure. But even their mind and conscience is defiled. That's why they keep doting about questions.
Yep.
Strifes of words. They profess that they know the Most High, but in works they deny him, being abominable and disobedient and unto every good work, reprobate.
And what does the word reprobate mean? Look up the word reprobate in the blue letter.
Void of judgment.
Void of understanding. The Most High have opened up your eyes.
That was Titus 1:16. That's why they question everything, because in reality, really, you're a reprobate. This truth is easy. I think Yahweh Shai said that. He said, my yoke is easy to bear.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this truth is not complicated.
Well, who said that? Was it Peter that said that? The simplicity that's in the gospel.
Either
Peter or Paul said that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep.
It's G96. Adokimos. Unapproved, that is, rejected. By implication, worthless, literally or morally. Cast away, rejected, reprobate.
Mm.
Let me see if I look up.
That's why guys fall off. I was speaking about Patak in the video I did earlier. Patak basically questioned us, going off on that. And I even said in the video how he figured he messed up, so he's trying to get in. But he said in his mind, I'm going to get into the head of New York. Let me try to get into the GMS Dallas. And remember, I cursed out GMS Dallas. I said, motherfucker, you ain't the head, man. Then it shook up everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Because these guys were novices. They were young in this thing. Well, we can, you know, we saw in the spirit that man wasn't right.
Yeah.
We saw in the spirit. The man said, I ain't budging. I said, okay, you don't have to budge. You know? And the same thing with Nazariah. Nazariah just knew the most I was dealing with him. Yep. Where is he now? He was solid with his men for about a year. And then for a whole year, he didn't do shit. And then he just popped up for about a month, did two videos, and you don't see him no more.
What? Huh? Flash in the pan.
So for that, literally, man. And that, and immediately what came to mind is Matthew's 25th chapter. 10 virgins, mm-hmm. 5 were wise and 5 were foolish.
Right. So that means they trimmed the lamp. The lamp came on, but it went right out.
It kind of, wow, that's a bright.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
And like the scripture, what is that? Matthew, where it says, and how great is that darkness?
How great is the blessed Matthew's 6 and 20.
I got
24 around here.
I got a quick precept.
Let's read that one too. That's a good one.
Okay.
First Timothy.
Oh, I looked at the clock.
Yeah, 4:44. Okay. Yeah. First Timothy 3 and 6. It says, not a novice, least being lifted up with pride, you fall into the condemnation of the devil.
You know what that means? Deeper than my teachers. Deeper than them. And then what happens is the spirit, the Most High just take that spirit from you.
Yeah.
And that's why King David said, take that away from you, thy Holy Spirit.
Yeah, the spirit. Yeah, when you look up the word novice in the Greek, it's
Strong's G-35-04. Neophytos. Neophytos.
Yep, it says newly planted, a new convert, a neophyte, one who has recently become a Christian and been brought into the truth. You would be a novice.
And then demons know whether you're a novice or not.
Yeah, they know.
Because they test your ass.
Yeah.
This is Numbers, I'm sorry, keep saying Numbers. Matthew 6:22. It says, the light of the body is the eye.
20,
okay. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your heart, I'm sorry, for where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. The light of the body is the eye. If therefore thine eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light.
So when you don't do this thing, it says in the Apocrypha, it said, putting that off the Lord day to day.
Contact.
So you got guys that take a little week off over here, go to Las Vegas with their chick for 2 weeks over there. Their auntie, their favorite auntie, sick out in California, so they go out there, you know? Then they hang out with some Israelites that really don't want to do the work, but they want to go out on boat trips or something like that, or go bowling or the shooting range.
They're pleasure seekers,
you know? The Most High is not dealing with that, man. We're in the work right now, man.
Yeah.
The night cometh where no man can work. So this is the time you're supposed to work. You don't take no breaks. We haven't taken a break. We're here right now in the studio.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Break, but my thing is, what is that world taking a break for?
Well, there's a lot of things. There's money. There's
call it as if you're into the world, but if you're really into the truth.
The world. Well, you nailed it on the head. They love the world. Heaven loved this. Give me that. Second Timothy 4.
Yeah, if you're really into this truth.
Heaven love this present world.
Yeah, if you're really into this truth, you really hate this world. Straight up.
Woo!
I started, it's 2 Timothy 4, I started 8. It says, henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge.
Oh, read up above that.
About
what he says about his departure.
Okay.
And this is for what is his name? ETT or whatever his name.
Oh, that guy.
Oh, end time teachers.
End time teachers.
Yeah. Verse 6. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand.
Is it talking about him going on a plane?
No.
I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be. But no.
No.
It's talking about him going before the Roman authorities because they had him on trial.
Right.
Right?
Right.
So they sentenced him. They said, okay, you're going to die now.
Yep.
For the charges, being condemned for the charges of sedition.
Sedition, okay.
You know? Because when they were talking about the kingdom, the Roman authorities took that as a threat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That there's going to be an army that's going to come and take that sedition.
Yep.
Peter was guilty of sedition. The Apostle Paul was guilty of sedition.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And the reason why they crucified that heinous, that was a heinous act to die by crucifixion.
Yeah.
That was a horrible, heinous death.
Yeah.
Yep.
So they said, well, you're a Roman citizen, so we're not going to give you that heinous
death.
We're just going to chop your head off. And then Paul knew it. And Paul went, and the story and the history goes that Peter was trying to run away from the Roman authorities, and he saw Yahweh Shai come. This is in the history, it's not in the scriptures. And he saw Yahweh Shai coming, and he said, Lord, what are you doing walking? He said, I'm going to go over there and get crucified again. And then Peter felt bad and walked back and gave himself up to the Romans. Like I said, that's in the history,
right,
outside the scriptures.
Yeah.
Okay, but Paul went. He said, okay, I'm going to go face death. They're the authority. The reason why I said all that is for my man, E.T.T., that the Romans in 13 chapters talking about the Roman Empire. How do we know that? When you read down about the 5th, 6th, 7th verse,
yeah,
it tells you tribute to who tribute is to.
Okay.
Do. Who is tribute to? It wasn't the Israelite authorities. It was the Romans, because they received tribute, which was taxes.
Yahusha asked about whose superscription.
Exactly. So the Apostle Paul backed up with Yahusha said.
Right.
Render unto Caesar for the Caesar, and render unto the Most High with the Most High.
That's it.
So Deacon the car had went off. He went off. They go off on certain things. They on a lot of things, but they off on certain things.
Yeah, because they're novices.
They're novices.
You guys are still novices. Even though he wouldn't feel that way, but you are.
They know the scriptures. They know a lot of things. But they go off on things.
Yeah, the scripture where it says no.
Because please tell me, go to Romans, go right to it. Romans, Romans 13. Read like the first two verses, then you can jump down and read really quick where it says tribute. And then look up the word tribute. It means tax. They weren't paying taxes to the so-called Jewish leaders. They were paying it to the Romans. Because what did the Romans do if you didn't pay taxes? They were going to send their army on you.
That's right.
And what Paul was saying is, don't gather a bunch of you all together because Israel, the saints are getting big. So he said, don't let that go into your head and think you're going to take down the Roman Empire because they have the power. And like my man, and they'll get up in your butt.
All right, up in your butt.
Go ahead.
Romans 13:1. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers.
That's the Most High. Go ahead.
For there is no power but that of the Most High.
Of the Most High. Go ahead.
The powers that be are ordained of the Most
High. Who's the powers that be? The Roman Empire. So how do we apply it today? We ain't talking about the ancient Roman Empire. We're talking about this system that we're under.
America.
Yeah, that's right. Go ahead.
Whosoever therefore resisted the power.
What does it mean to resist?
Fight
to take up arms against them. Because
yep.
You're going to lose. You know, he that beareth the sword, beareth not the sword in vain, or he that kills with the sword must be killed with the sword. And the Lord told Peter when he chopped off Malcolm's ear, he said,
He said, he that liveth by the sword
shall die by the sword. Yeah.
I got a couple of examples. Couple of guys who came against the Roman Empire, Acts 5 and 36 and 37. Before these days rose up Thutis, boasting himself to be somebody.
So now let's say Thutis. Who would be Thutis today? That would be Grandmaster Jay, right?
Grandmaster Jay.
He rolled up with the guns. And you don't see him no more.
Right.
The last time we put up a video, he took off the comment section because people cursed his ass out.
Yeah. He's been found out.
Acts 5 and 36, for before these days rose up Thutis, boasted himself to be somebody, to whom a number of men, about 400, joined themselves, who was slain,
Wait, what does the word slave mean? How many men drowned himself?
400.
400. What happened to them? They all got put to death.
Yeah.
And Esau is showing his power right now. Because the lamb with two horns and speak as a dragon. Now we know what that means.
Right.
He's speaking as a dragon right the fuck now.
Yep.
Yep.
Excuse my Swedish.
Yeah, because he know that his time is short. They know they got to get this new world order popping.
Why do they got to get the new world order popping? Because they got to get the digital oils in them. So when the Lord come to deliver us, you're going to see them Lucifer for race. He said, no, we can sold out. Fuck them. You know, just keep going, Habitat. Just keep going.
Right.
Go back in this. I'll make a new nation. Well, that's not going to happen.
Right.
You know?
Because the Lord got the elect.
He got the elect.
Mm-hmm. The 7,000 men that have not bowed the knee.
That's in this case, it's 144,000 plus the one-third.
Yep. Acts 5 and 36. For before these days rose up Judas, boasting himself to be somebody, to whom a number of men, about 400, joined themselves who were slain, and all as many as obeyed him were scattered and brought to naught. After this man rose up Judas of Galilee in the days of the taxing.
Right.
And why in the days of the taxing? Because they were heavily taxing me. The Roman so-called Jewish wars were over the fact that the Romans during the time of Nero, and then you had the four Caesars, and then you had Vespasian and Titus, is because they were taxing the hell out of Jacob and Esau. So it's like, we ain't paying these fucking taxes, we gonna go, you know?
Yeah.
Now, why do you think they had this whole thing set up with the National Guard going down to D.C.? It was like, how many of them? It was like 25,000 of them. But now they're 5,000, and they're saying that them fencing the National Guard, the 5,000 gonna be there permanently.
See,
why do you think they did that?
Because it's gonna be.
Because something's gonna happen where they gonna go. This time, people gonna really go down them, and they're gonna be ready.
Yeah.
They're gonna be ready. Because we know that the first thing was a setup.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When they bust in the Capitol building, you can see that they pulled out the real windows and put that breakaway windows, and it was plexiglass. Wait a minute, that's the great Capitol. You got plexiglass?
Bullshit,
but people don't see it.
Yeah.
You know, but they're ready this time because motherfuckers are going to be starving out here.
Oh, yeah.
Second Ezra, the 15th chapter, is going to take place in a big way.
Yeah.
So they're going to be going down and they're going to get these motherfuckers from that boat. Oh, they're going to have the troops there, man.
Well, I went to this one place where I usually get gas, and usually the gas prices were between $2.15 to $2.19. Last time I went, it jumped up to like $2.47.
Well, it's happening right down here in New York.
Yeah, and the silver prices just jumped up, you know?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, so hey, things are happening, man.
They keep on pumping money into the economy, so you gotta pay more for shit.
Well, inflation, hyperinflation works is when they push money, digital money and paper money into the system, and people spend it, and that's why they give you stimulus, to spend it into, you know,
the economy.
But now if they hold it, I'm going to hold it. You're not going to experience hyperinflation. Hyperinflation takes place when you put those extra dollars into the system, you know?
Like that old soup analogy, put more water in the soup.
Yeah, so alcohol. You go to a bar, they water down the, you know.
Watering the alcohol.
That's it. Watering down whatever. Go ahead. Where we at?
Acts 5 and 37. After this man rose up Judas of Galilee in the days of the taxing and drew away much people after him, he also perished. And all, even as many as obeyed him, were dispersed.
Yeah.
So that's a couple of examples of individuals that came up against the Roman government. What happened to them? They were put to death.
Yeah.
Okay, because they came up against the Roman government carnally. And Esau's power is the sword. And that's why we keep telling you Jakes out there, you ain't going to beat Esau by the sword because his power is the sword. Yahushua is the one that's coming with the angels to beat Esau. As a matter of fact, since I said that, let me get the scripture.
Yeah.
I don't know if you got a point.
Yeah, because there were a lot of revolts back then against the Roman Empire because of the taxation.
That's right.
You know, that's why you had people that were come up and will be put back down. And the reason why they weren't able to take the Roman Empire down, even though it seemed like at times that they probably had them cornered, is because the Lord set them up in prophecy.
They had to
rule because that was who the Lord put up in power.
That's right.
The camera's good?
Yep.
1 Corinthians 15 and 24, it says, then cometh the end when he shall have delivered up the kingdom to the Most High. He is Yahweh Shai. Even the Father, Yahweh, when he shall have put down all rule and all authority and power.
He set it up. The Lord said he promote. He's promotion coming either from the east or the west, but the Most High setteth up one and taketh down another. So until the time is set, that empire is not going to fall. You know, there's certain things that happen in prophecy that lead up to that particular empire falling.
Yeah, since you said that, Isaiah 63 is a prophecy. Because when Yahweh Shai comes back, who's he going to zero in on?
Right.
Esau.
Which goes with the second half of the sixth. That Esau is the end of the world. You know, the end of the age.
Yeah, not Asa. Esau.
Right.
This guy is clown. Janet Joplin. What's his name?
Oh, Gino Jennings.
Janet Joplin. He's a clown. He's a damn clown, man.
Yep.
And all those Christians, and now they're slowly going. We pick up the Apocrypha from watching us.
Yeah.
You know?
Never heard nobody going to the Apocrypha.
Yep, here's the prophecy.
I can remember.
Isaiah 63 and 1, it says, who is this that cometh from Edom?
With thy garments.
Right. Thy garments from Bozrah. This that is glorious in his apparel, traveling in the greatness of his strength, I that speak in righteousness, mighty to save. Wherefore art thou red in thine apparel, and thy garments like him that treadeth in the wine fat. I have trodden the winepress alone, and of the people there was none with me, for I will tread them in mine anger and trample them in my fury.
We'll show you that this devil has to be taken down by the force of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai.
By way of the great millstone.
Yeah. Because they were set up, they got into that power, they were given the blessing of the sword.
Mm-hmm.
They took the world by violence and they have to be brought down by violence.
Yep.
But there's no
he that killeth by the sword must be killed by the sword. Uh-huh. He that leaveth in captivity must go into captivity.
Uh-huh. Yep. And there's no opponent out there strong enough to take these devils down.
Uh-huh.
That's why Yahweh Shai is coming back.
He said, I'll not meet thee as a
man. That's right.
Isaiah 63 and 3, I have trodden the winepress alone, and of the people there was none with me. For I will tread them in mine anger, and trample them in my fury.
Yeah.
And their blood shall be sprinkled upon my garments.
Hey, that's why Yahweh Shai said to Pontius Pilate, if my kingdom were of this world, then will my servants
fight. Yep. So this is not our world.
That's right.
It has to be a change of worlds.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
So when Yahweh Shai comes back, he's coming to do battle with
him. Right, he's bringing that, what do you call that, the world engine.
That's bad.
Superman. Man of Steel. Because I was rooting for General Zod. Right. I don't know about you, brother.
I wasn't rooting
for the Uncle Tom.
Nah.
You know? And he dope, because when he went on the ship, the atmosphere was different. And, this guy, Superman, Kal-El, he kind of coughed. And then Zod looked at him. He said, you're not even used to our atmosphere. You know, like you fucking Uncle Tom.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
You're way beneath.
Yeah, he was a Tom. Gave up his
and he said it would take a little while for your system to get back used to it, man. And what he did was, when he sent down that world engine, it went into the ground, and it was changing the whole atmosphere from a earthly atmosphere to a kryptonic atmosphere.
Right, right,
so that was going to be the new Krypton,
right.
You know?
Hey, that the scriptures say that, Lord, where the new world where righteousness dwelleth, so that the old world is going out and the new
with the world engine. Yeah.
That's bad.
Hey, you watch the Superman, Superman movie. And them motherfuckers, the giant dude and the woman, they were trying to fuck, you know, Kal-El ass up.
Yeah.
He was fighting for them crackers, man.
Yeah.
Trying to preserve.
See, the real way he was supposed to come like what's the one where he's a little boy?
Oh yeah, Brightburn.
Brightburn. Mm. That was the way you're supposed to come.
Right.
Kill everybody, man. Right. You know, kill your daddy, kill your mommy. Take your mother up in the closet, throw her ass down. Mm. Fuck that shit.
And
I mean, hey brother, when I saw that movie, I went to my demon one. I said, fuck you, I'm gonna see it.
Oh, yeah.
Because the first person I heard speak about it was Malcolm, you know, the elder of GMS Chicago. And I guess he didn't get into it like I got into it.
Yeah.
He kind of said, yeah, it's good. I said, let me go see that. Man, I got all into it, man. Nobody was around me. It was maybe three other people in the theater, and I got all into it. And I was like, yeah. when I left out, I had the camera in my car, and it was raining, pouring, and I made the video right there.
Video.
I said, you got to see that, you got to see that movie, man. And then all the brothers started seeing it, you know?
God.
I said, that's the way Kal-El was supposed to come, man.
Right.
Yeah.
He was playing.
I got a quick precept since you're saying all that. Isaiah 66 and 15.
Oh, and then he even got in a woman. He fell in love with the little girl, and she said he was a weirdo.
Well,
we are weirdos. Men are weirdos to women.
Yep.
You got a weird. You pick up frogs and shit. Yeah, we are supposed to be weird to you.
Right.
You know, and you're weird to us in a sexual way.
Right.
And you know when he got into the girl? When he was 12 years old.
Mm.
And she was 12 and she didn't understand.
Yeah.
You're a pervert. No, he wasn't a pervert. What the fuck you mean? What motherfucker, what is a pervert?
Right.
You know?
Right. Yep. Isaiah 66 and 15, for behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind to render his anger with fury.
I'm sorry, one more thing. Mm. When that ship that was under in the garage or the attic or whatever, and started communicating with him when he was 12 years old.
Yeah.
And when he was 12 years old,
it was like calling him.
It was calling him.
Like,
and he was like,
they showing you that they were Israelites because his name was Kal-El.
Yeah.
And he was all powerful.
He was trying to find out where that voice was coming from.
Yep, that's
right,
it.
Right.
That's it.
Yeah, that's it.
And he kept getting drawn to it more and more.
And his parents kind of kept him from it.
Yeah.
You know? That's why ultimately he killed both of them.
Yeah,
like Samuel. Remember he kept hearing voices?
Yeah.
And then Eli said, look, next time you hear the voice,
right.
You say, here I am, O Lord.
Yeah, because he thought it was Eli calling.
Calling,
that's it. It was the Lord. That's how the Lord operates, man.
Yeah.
Yep, Isaiah 66 and 15, for behold.
This is the way to walk you in it when you turn to the
Lord. That's it.
When you hear the calling.
Yep.
Proverbs, the first chapter.
Yeah, that's a lesson right there, when you hear the calling.
Yeah.
That's a damn thing.
When you come calling.
Yeah, when you come, I was talking about that, yeah. Oh, man,
Calvin Locker.
Yeah, what was his character's name?
King something. King Louis.
Yeah, King Louis.
Yeah. When him come calling, which he's Bohemian.
Yeah, which is Benjamin.
Benjamin. Isaiah 66 and 15, for behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind. Those chariots are the so-called UFOs, which that's what the so-called white man calls them, UFOs. With his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. Because out of them chariots, some of those chariots, laser beams of fire is going to come out and burn up the infrastructure, burn up people. People are going to be running.
When you read the scriptures and you pick out certain things in the scriptures, you can clearly see.
You can see it.
You can see that it's talking about UFOs.
Yep.
You can see that it's talking about lasers coming from the UFOs.
Absolutely, yep. And the movie that dramatized that was War of the Worlds, but the thing about that movie is they gave the credit to little green men from Mars.
Right.
It's not little green men from Mars. It's going to be Yahawashi and the angels. Which Yahawashi is a so-called black man.
Yep.
And so are the angels. They're dark-skinned men.
Which they show you in the first War of the World, they show you the pink, the glass thing.
In the 50s, back in the stained glass window. Because we actually saw it. If you pause, if you have a good VCR, like back in the day, if you had a forehead VCR, you had the two heads and you had the forehead.
Right.
If you pause the forehead VCR, you got a clearer picture.
Right.
The two head had that squiggly line going up right. So we had that forehead VCR, we paused it, and there you can see a clear stained glass image of basically Yahawashi.
Yeah.
And they all, oh, by the way, in the movie, they all ran into the church.
Yep.
They all ran into the church for centuries. Why? There it is, the aliens were attacking and they ran into the church for sanctuary. They showed you right there. So, and that's exactly what's going to happen to you people out there. One of these days, we're going to wake up, like it says in Revelation 1 and 7, behold, he comes with clouds, and every eye shall see. The skies are going to be covered with so-called UFOs, chariots. Okay? That's all.
You got more?
I got a precept, if I can.
Oh, we can go back to Numbers.
Okay, Numbers 12.
Yeah. Okay. And then we got to go to 2 Ezra 14.
You said you had a precept.
Yeah, 1 Thessalonians 5, concerning these people out here. It says, 1 Thessalonians 5 and 1, it says, but of the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need that I write unto you. For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night.
But not for us.
But not for us. Right.
Constantly looking for it today.
Right. Come.
These people ain't looking for the day.
Right. Mm-hmm. Habakkuk said, I will stand upon my watch and look to see what the Most High will say. You know?
Yeah, so did Job. Job said, I know out of my body I will see how it shall come. He said, out of the flesh.
In my flesh,
Yeah, roughly paraphrasing. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So Job knew he was going to be back in the reincarnation because he said, I'm going to see that my Lord, my Redeemer, and out of flesh.
Right.
Now we know Job died back there.
Right.
So what does he mean by that? Meaning he knew he would come back in his generation, and he would come back in a generation when Yahweh Shai is coming back. And we believe that we're in that generation now.
Which proved that Job was a prophet.
There you go.
I think Yahweh Shai at the end of John, John, he said, what I say unto you, I say unto all, watch.
And that's exactly what we're doing. I mean, you can tell by our videos. Each video we do is all about prophecy. The main prophecy we're talking about is that chip.
Yeah.
We're watching to see.
Because that's the next big thing. Yeah. That's the thing that we're looking for.
It is.
That's the next big major thing that we're looking for, prophecy to be fulfilled.
That's it. So
because
we'll
that's going to move everything forward faster. You know? Because the world wars, they could break out and it could be something done quick.
Yep.
You know? But see, with this chip, they want to put it into every individual. So they got to create the right scenario. They got to have the infrastructure. Then they got to get people accustomed to it, you know, and inject them.
Which they got the right scenario, that Maxine nonsense.
Oh, matter of fact, that I'm sorry, Pastor.
No, you got
that. On Amazon Prime, Utopia and Dystopia, those two series, they pretty much show you that the people had a chip. But the way they show it like a barcode on the back of their wrist, and they said that everybody that got injected with that was immune from the virus, because what happened was they went back in time, and the one jaked after his father was dying of cancer, and the one guy that went back in time, he took out some blood out of his himself and injected, you know, the doctor's father with it, and within days the father got better and all signs of cancer were gone from him. You know, so it was a thing where that whatever they injected them with is supposed to have got eradicated all those diseases.
You know, like the Crippen virus.
Yep. Yeah, I was just thinking that.
Yeah, because, yeah.
Will Smith's blood was the antidote.
Yep, that's it.
I can save you.
Yeah, that dude wasn't trying to hit nothing, man. You had his woman, he wanted to take your ass out.
You don't mess with him.
You don't mess with a man's robot, his robot.
Yeah, robot.
A zombie's woman.
Yeah.
Even if he is a zombie.
Yeah, exactly. What?
Number. Did you finish your
precept? Yeah, that was pretty much the point.
Okay,
you know.
Numbers. Numbers 12:4, it says, and the Lord spake suddenly unto Moses and unto Aaron and unto Miriam. No, I didn't read the third verse. Right. Now the man Moses was very meek above all the men which were upon the face of the earth. And the Lord spake suddenly unto Moses and unto Aaron and unto Miriam, come out, ye three, unto the tabernacle of the congregation. And they three came out. And the Lord came down in the pillar of the cloud, which would be a so-called UFO.
Yep.
And stood in the door of the tabernacle. Now, clouds, straight up clouds don't have doors. So that had, that would have had to be...
Well, they were talking about the door of the tabernacle. Let the ship, the door of the tabernacle.
Come.
The entrance to the tabernacle.
Come. And stood in the door of the tabernacle and called Aaron and Miriam, and they both came forth. And he said, hear now my words, if there be a prophet among you, I, the Lord, will make myself known unto him in a vision and will speak unto him in a dream. My servant Moses is not so, which is faithful in all mine house. With him will I speak mouth to mouth, and even apparently, and not in dark speeches, and the similitude of the Lord shall he be beheld or behold. Wherefore then were ye not afraid to speak against my servant Moses? And the anger of the Lord was kindled against them, and he departed. And the cloud departed from off the tabernacle. Come, come. And behold, Miriam became leprous, white as snow. That was a punishment.
Yeah, he didn't do it. He didn't punish Aaron because Aaron was a man. Right. This was a woman. Right. This was a woman. Right. So you were completely out of order.
Yep. Yeah. Lord.
And she got straight. Oh. You know what? You know what's going to get you, nigga woman, straight? Mosaic and leprosize your ass.
Yeah. Some of them, they'll probably be dancing down the street. I'm a white girl now.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, get, yeah. Run and get the blonde wig.
Yeah, no, you can't, they ain't going to be wearing no blonde wigs in the kingdom.
That's the number one weave and wig that you...
Yeah, because you're fucked up in the head.
Because you're all messed up in the head.
Man. Unbelievable.
You get the blonde. And then when you read the scriptures, it shows you, a lot of you so-called black women, you go to these churches, right? And you be the ones wearing the blonde weaves and wigs. It tells you in the scripture, if you have blonde hair, that's leprosy.
Well,
of
they
the
don't
scalp.
Have to be, Doc. They don't have to be. That's leprosy. They got the only thing they do with the Bible is put it on their arm.
Yeah, that's it.
On all that.
So that's proof that's right. That's proof that you ain't reading the scriptures. Also proof that your so-called pastor is not teaching you the scriptures. Because as soon as, let's say, you walk in the congregation, you got that stupid blonde weave or wig on your head. Your pastor is supposed to say, sister, do you know that having blonde hair is leprosy?
Well, that nigga don't know.
He
don't know.
The show's right.
The church is a big joke. It's a major joke.
It's a whorehouse.
He said his wife has a blonde wig.
Yeah.
Yeah, his wife has a blonde weave. And that's man, what is it? Why are you, somebody should put that in the comment section. Why are you so-called black women enamored with the blonde, you know, of all the color you can get brunette.
They want to be like the white girl.
You want to get the blonde.
They want to be the ultimate white chick.
What's up with that, you know?
They like in the movie White.
Oh, yeah. I was thinking about with the Wayne brothers. Yeah.
Blonde weave, blonde wig. That's the number one. If you don't believe us, just Google it. Black women and blonde weaves. And
you don't see white women working on Wall Street. Well, not Wall Street. They're working in an office building. Wall Street is dead.
Right.
With dreadlocks, they wouldn't get the job. They wouldn't get the job. And you see a white woman with dreadlocks, you know she's getting pumped by some Benjaminite.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Yep.
I got a precept.
Actually, what was that movie? What's that guy's name? He said the brothers went down with rifles and came back with jobs.
I'm going to get you something.
Yeah, with the white chick that was with.
Yeah. Little kid, white, black, power.
Nah, that's true. That's very true.
Yeah.
The so-called Rastas, they like to get the white woman.
He said, whitey, is it true?
Yeah, whitey, is it true? Yeah. Yeah, well, Jake is all fucked up.
Yeah.
And Jake is messed up in the head. Mm-hmm. He's crazy. He's bugged out. Mm-hmm. He's gone. He needs a spiritual...
Yeah.
The
yep. Yeah. That's how you know who Jake is, because that was the Lord said he will make a sign to the nations to show them who the Israelites are by what they go through, you know?
Yep, I got a precept to back you up, Apostle. Isaiah 1 and 3. The ox knoweth his owner, and the ass his master's crib. Mm. But Israel doth not know. My people doth not consider. Our sinful nation, the people laden with iniquity. A seed of evildoers, children that are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger. They are gone away backward. Why should ye be stricken any more? You will revolt more and more. The whole head is sick. and the whole heart faint. From the sole of the foot, even unto the head, there is no soundness in it. Meaning you don't have this knowledge, you don't have this truth. That's what brings you brings a sound mind.
Yeah.
The scriptures speak about sound doctrine.
Yep.
That cannot be, this is the sound doctrine. So if you have this truth, you're sound. No.
Yeah. The Lord said he healed them with his word.
Yeah. Yep. Uh-huh. Also it's written, and knowledge and wisdom shall be the stability.
Times,
knowledge and wisdom of what? This truth, this knowledge.
The scriptures speak about healing in his wings.
Yeah, healing in his wings.
Yep.
Yeah.
I have a precept.
Yep, yeah.
This is Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 32. And it says, Can a maid forget her ornaments, or a bride her attire? Yet my people have forgotten me days without number. Why trimmest thou thy way to seek love? Therefore hast thou also taught the wicked ones thy ways. And I believe there's another scripture in Jeremiah says that my people have become more wicked than the wicked. So the wicked trying to be like these wicked ass niggas. You know? That's something. Because Esau is the wicked, but Jake overtook them in wickedness, man.
All right, go to 11 verse. I hope I'm in the right.
This is the second chapter. Okay.
I'm in the right. I think I am.
Okay. Yeah. This is Jeremiah 2 and 11. Hath a nation changed their gods?
Yeah, have a nation changed their gods?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Which are yet no gods.
Yeah, Esau's not a god.
Right.
Well, that cuts Nate. The Almighty Nate.
Mm-hmm.
You change your god for that which is no god.
That's right.
What the hell do you mean Christ? Most High Christ. Right. Most High God. Christ blessed.
Broken systems, man.
Go ahead.
Which are yet no gods. But my people have changed their glory for that which doth not profit.
Yeah, but the woman, like you said, with black woman wearing wigs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And you look like a fucking clown.
You look like a clown.
You see a woman mm-hmm. with a black, she's a black as tar.
Yeah.
Nappy-headed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, I heard she got that nasty woman disease. Mm-hmm. I had to throw that in there.
Yeah.
And she is black as tar with the brightest, longest
weave.
Not weave, wig.
Mm-hmm.
And don't you know when the white man sees you, they laugh at you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah.
It's look
oh,
at this yeah. dumb black bitch.
Mm-hmm.
Look at this dumb nigga bitch.
Does she really think she's blonde?
She thinks she's blonde. She thinks she looks good. There's nothing good. You look, you know.
Like a horror.
I think in that movie, The Gremlins, there was one of the Gremlins that put on a blonde wig with some lipstick.
Yeah, because that was the Gremlins was code for niggas.
Yep. I forgot my man's
name. The real name of the movie is niggas. You know?
Yeah, the
blonde. You remember that? I forgot to do the.
So, yeah,
they tamed
them,
they got them
yeah.
in the movie theater.
Yeah.
They tamed them with the Snow White in the Seven Dwarfs.
Oh, yeah, I was watching
it. They were singing, they were eating popcorn. They were acting just like niggas.
Damn, man.
And Shia, that's when the movie came out in the late 80s,
right.
early 90s. And Shia, boy, he's always quoted that movie. He said, you know how they got you niggas? They got you in the movie and burnt your ass. And they even had a scene where they had a Kremlin that looked just like a Thelonious Monk.
Oh, okay, yeah.
You know?
I got a quick precept. 2 Timothy 3.
Or they call him Mogwai.
Mogwai.
And you know, Mogwai is either Cantonese or Mandarin for devil. Mogwai means devil.
Oh,
so
shit.
It was calling them devils, you know? What's his name? Mogwai? Black devil.
2 Timothy 3 and 6. For this sort are they which creep into houses and lead captive silly women laden with sins, led away with diverse lusts.
Yeah, these guys that have these camps with a lot of women in, there's all kind of debauchery going on, all kind of
silly women.
Skullduggery, which by the way, skullduggery means adultery. That's what it means. It doesn't mean ripping somebody off, it means skullduggery. It means adultery.
Look at that.
I got a quick one. It's Jeremiah.
Look it up, y'all don't believe me.
Oh, no.
Jeremiah 4:22. For my people is foolish. They have not known me. They are sottish children.
Yeah, sottish. We looked that up. It means stupid.
And they have none understanding.
None understanding. Oh, also, was it Yahweh said that? The children of this world is wiser than the children of light. The children of light is talking about Israelites.
Yep.
The children of this world is talking about Esau.
Esau, yep. It said they are wise to do evil, but to do good they have no knowledge.
That's good.
Did you have more stuff?
No.
So we can go to where?
Yeah.
Another piece of
that was it.
So we can go to where I first said.
Second Ezra.
Sorry. Second Ezra 14:1.
You got it?
I got it.
Yeah, okay.
2 Ezra chapter 14, verse 1. And it came to pass upon the third day, was what, 30 years old?
Yeah.
And it came to pass upon the third day, I sat under an oak. And behold, there came a voice out of a bush over against me and said, Ezra, Ezra. And I said, here am I, Lord. And I stood up upon my feet. Then said he unto me, in the bush I did manifestly reveal myself unto Moses and talk with him when my people served in Egypt. And I sent him and led my
people. You can speak on it.
Come. Yeah, this is going into the burning bush, which is Yahushua speaking to Moses when he called unto Moses. Because that's when the Lord was calling. Oh, we were speaking about the calling earlier.
Yep.
You know, the Lord was. That was when the Lord was calling out to Moses to build him up to go to Egypt to deliver the children of Israel from under the hand of Pharaoh. Mm-hmm. It says, and I sent him and led my people out of Egypt and brought him up to the mount of where I held him by me a long season. Right, that was 40 days and 40 nights where the Lord showed him. See, the Lord gave him laws, statutes, commandments. He gave him the two tables of stone written with the finger of the Most High, the Ten Commandments, which was an instruction or guideline for the rest of the laws.
Mm-hmm.
But he also showed him a lot of different visions. See, this is why he was up there so long. Because it don't take 40 days and 40 nights.
Right, as you read on, I don't know if you read it because I'm into this right here. But it said he showed him the prophecies in the last days.
Kind of, that's right.
So he saw the chip, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Oh, by the way, I looked up skullduggery in the Common Dictionary. It says trickery, which is bullshit. So I went to the etymon online. Skullduggery, fornication.
Mm. Well, which is adultery.
Which is adultery. Then it goes on and says from 1856, apparently, an alteration of Scottish skullduggery, which is adultery.
See? That's what it literally means.
That's what it literally means. Huh?
Gone.
Go ahead.
You said you had something?
Sorry. Yeah, this is 2 Ezra 14:1.
No, that's what I'm reading.
Oh, that's what you're reading? Oh, Salakip. Sorry.
That's all right. It's the spirit, bro.
It's the spirit.
Salak.
Verse 5. And I told him many wondrous things and showed him the secrets of time, of the times.
He showed Moses what's happening now. He showed him America.
Yep.
He showed him the destruction. He showed him the house shine. He showed him the chip.
Chip, yeah. He showed him the creation.
Showed him the creation.
That's
yeah.
How he was able to write everything.
Oh, well, Genesis 1, Genesis
yeah.
2.
Yeah.
He showed him what the serpent was.
Yeah.
So the Lord, the reason why we know it's right and exact is because the Most High showed him.
Right.
He said, this is what happened in the beginning.
Yeah.
This is how the heavens were made. You know, this is how man was made, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. It said, told him many wondrous things and showed him the secrets of the times and the end.
And the end.
Yeah.
So what did Moses see? Moses saw the missiles.
Yeah.
Moses saw the race riots.
Sure.
Well, not the race riots, it's riots. Because now these riots are just Moses beating the shit out of everybody. You know, Edomites beating the hell out of them. Like you got the Proud Boys beating the hell out of the Antifa, which they're both Edomites.
Right.
Now the head guy of the Proud Boys is a Manassite,
right.
And then come to find out this guy was an informant.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
I figured that. That dude was a fucking paid mofo.
It says, and commanded him, saying, these words shalt thou declare, and these shalt thou hide. And the Lord also showed us King Solomon the beginning, the ending, and the midst of the time.
In the midst of the time, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. It says, and now I say unto thee that thou lay up in thy heart the signs that I have showed and the dreams that thou hast seen.
So now some dreams are from a multitude of business. Some dreams are from eating a bad tuna fish sandwich.
Yep.
And some dreams are actually visions.
Yep. And the interpretations which thou hast heard.
The breakdowns. The hermeneutics. You know, the exegesis.
It says, for thou shalt be taken away from all, and from henceforth thou shalt remain with my son.
I got a quick precept.
So the son was all in the spiritual realm. The son was already in his position.
Yeah.
In the spiritual realm, the angels knew that that was his son.
Yeah.
That's why when the demons encountered him, he called on his name, because the demons was up in the spiritual world.
Yeah.
Oh, they're going to have a shot.
Yeah.
Then they all came down in the flesh.
Yeah.
And they, you know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That was the principalities.
Principalities, yeah.
I got a quick precept about dreams. This is Ecclesiasticus 34 and 5. Divinations and soothsayings and dreams are vain, and the heart fancieth as a woman's heart in travail. If they be not sent from the Most High in thy visitation,
which is a vision,
right? Set not thy heart upon them, for dreams have deceived many. And they have failed that put their trust in them. That's pretty much it. The little thing on dreams.
Right, because they said they have failed that put their trust in them, because, you know, just because you have a dream doesn't mean that that's actually going to happen that way.
Yeah, the sixth verse, it says, if they be not sent.
It's like a pastor. I can use it back on that.
Go ahead.
Pastor Tara had mentioned about, you know, Nate or Bishop Nathaniel, because they get mad, you call him Nate. You know, that he had a dream about King David, King Masha, you know, that he said put pork juice in the rice or something like that, and that's how he knew that was a King David.
Yo, well, you can't go, what if you had a dream that your woman committed adultery?
Right.
And you going to kick her, kill her? Oh, I had a dream. You know?
Yeah.
And let me read you this here, Genesis 20, verse 1.
Mm-hmm.
And Abraham journeyed from thence toward the south country and dwelled between Kadesh and Shur. This is one of you civil ass niggas saying, if you have another nation, you can't get a dream or a vision. Well, I'm going to show you that the Lord dealt with other nations, gave dreams and visions. And sojourned in, what is this? Gerar. And Abraham said to Sarah, his wife, she is my sister. And Abimelech, king of Gerar, sent and took Sarah. But the Most High came to Abimelech in a dream by night. There's another nation. And said to him, behold, thou art but a dead man. For the woman which thou hast taken, she is a man's wife.
He scared the hell out of them too.
That was a vision in the form of a dream.
Yeah.
Right.
That goes with Joel, the second chapter. Acts, the second chapter.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, that was.
Yeah, because when the Lord said he's going to pour out all flesh, he was talking about other nations too.
Yeah.
They having dreams.
Yeah. Visions.
They having visions of the destruction and all that. Man.
Yeah.
That's why you see them get on camera and make those different videos. They're all frantic because they had just freshly woke up from those visions.
Yeah.
All right, so
here's another one, Genesis 31, verse 11. I'm just reading one verse. And the angel of the Most High spake unto me in a dream, saying, Yaqub, and I said, here am I.
Mm-hmm.
And that makes you think of the situation with
Samuel
and Eli.
Yep. That's right.
So go ahead, you got
it. This is back in 2 Ezra 14 and 9. For thou shalt be taken away from all, and from henceforth thou shalt remain with my son, and with such as be like thee unto the times be ended. For the world has lost its youth, and the times begin to wax old. For the world is
divided. Break it down as you go along.
Come. For the world hath lost its youth, and the times begin to wax old. So you're looking at around 400 or 500 BC,
right,
when Ezra was on the scene, you know, and you know the earth, most so-called scholars date the time of Adam to around 4000 BC, the time of Abraham around 2200 2000 BC, around there. King David, King Solomon, King Saul, around 1100 to 1000.
Well, you got to go back to the beginning of the earth and the universe. God. So we're talking how many years? We're talking what, if it's going on 14,000, if I'm not mistaken.
Something like that.
Something like that.
Yeah. Because as you read it, it's going to break the numbers down.
Yep. Because that's how the Lord set everything up. Time, you know, he set everything up in time.
Yeah, because the rebuilding of the second temple was around the 6th century B.C., you know, with Zerubbabel, Joshua the high priest, and all that.
Yeah, it says, for the world has lost its youth, and the times begin to wax old. For the world is divided into 12 parts.
Now, yeah, which represent 12,000 years.
Yep.
So when you add another 2,000 plus years, that's 14,000 years.
Yeah.
So the universe, the beginning of the universe, is about 14,000 years old.
Yeah.
It says, and 10 parts of it are gone already. That was it said, and half of a tenth part. So by the time the Ezra was on the scene, it had been about 9,500.
Yeah, 500 years before the birth of the Lord.
Yep. So those about almost 10 parts or 9.5 parts were gone. And then from the time that this vision was shown to him to Yahweh Shai was about another 500 years in the future. So that would have made the exact 10,000, which 10 is the representation of the kingdom.
Yeah, that makes sense.
You know?
Completion.
When David came, that was about 1,000.
1,000, yeah. 1,000
BC. You got tens in there, series of 10. Yeah.
So then when Yahweh Shai came on the scene, that ushered in his kingdom, which is about to be shown, which was 2,000 years into the future, which we're at that time now. It says, and there remaineth that which is after the half of the tenth part, which was the 500 years, till Yahweh Shai came on the scene. Now therefore set thine house in order, and reprove thy people. Comfort such of them as be in trouble, and now renounce corruption.
And that represents us now, as well.
Set thine house in order. The house that's being built up right now is the house of David.
Right. There's a scripture I was reading earlier. Speaks about, I think it's in the book of Isaiah, where it says, I will set them up as their former estate, you know, which goes back to what? The tabernacles of David that are fallen.
That's David's nine, right?
Kind of. You know, so that's what the Lord is doing now. He's raising up the tabernacles of David that are fallen.
Come.
Amos, the 9th chapter, 11th verse, it says, in that day, and you can expound, in that day will I raise up the tabernacle of David that is fallen.
Right, because that same, those same spirits that were back then with King David would be the first fruits, the ones that are going to be the 144,000, the ones that are going to be set up in the next kingdom, as in the book of Revelation speaks about the first resurrection. Blessed is he that has a part in the first resurrection. That's the first dominion, which is the first fruits, which are the first spirits that were created, you know?
The tabernacle of David that has fallen and close up the breaches thereof.
Right. The breaches are a representation of all the differences in between all the different tribes. Because you still have that to this day.
Yep. Yeah. And I will raise up his ruins, and I will build it as in the days of old.
Yeah, because we had fallen, and now the Lord is building it back up. But he's building it back up the right way.
As in the days of
old. As in the days of old, because during the 60s, 70s, 80s, you know, you had Jake coming together, but they didn't have that breath in them, as it speaks of in Ezekiel 37. You know, they were coming together under the being of the same nation or whatever the case is, but they didn't have the breath, which is this knowledge.
You know? These other camps that don't have the whole truth, they don't have the breath either. They don't have the whole breath. So they got to get the whole breath, which is the whole road.
The whole road.
Yeah. Otherwise, you 99.5 just won't do.
Hey, Apostle Paul said here. Apostle Paul said, "I have not shunned to declare unto you all the counsel of the Heavenly Father." So we're supposed to give you all the truth.
Yeah, but unction from the Holy One and you know all things.
Yeah. So then you got these other Israelites out there. They get mad when we say we got 100% truth. You know, they get mad and they get.
Well, why would you get mad at it when the scripture said you're supposed to have 100%
truth? 100%
truth.
No man can have 100% truth. No.
Well, they obviously don't understand.
Exactly.
Well, the Lord said that he will come and sup with those men. It says, 14 verse, 2 Corinthians 14:14. Let go from the mortal thoughts, cast away the burdens of man, put off now the weak nature, and set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee, and haste thee to flee from these times. Why? Because the hasting part is hasten for the Lord to come, watching, doing what the Lord said to do, so that when these things do come, that, you know, we may find...
Well, that's gay to hasten the Lord.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. But the scriptures tell you to hasten the Lord, so I guess the scriptures is gay.
I mean, the madness that comes out of
the madness that comes, that group, well, that group up there.
That's
a hell of a group.
Yeah. I mean, the reprobateness.
Well, the reprobateness is legendary.
Yeah, man.
God damn.
That's, I mean,
some simple ass niggas in Israel. That's all I gotta say.
The scriptures say, as a leader of the people, is, or his people, something.
Oh, like. So we know that the people, they rule.
You said you read Hasten the Times?
Yes.
Idiots par excellence.
Come on. Damn. It says, and set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee, and haste thee to flee from the times, times.
Be haste for to get out of here. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
Lord, when are you going to come?
Yeah.
Didn't that the prophets complain to the Lord?
Sure did.
Hold on, wait a minute. I guess it was gay for the apostles to say, well, Lord, this time is going to get the Lord. No, y'all being gay.
Yeah.
Y'all being gay.
I got a quick precept to back up what you just read. 1 Corinthians 7:29. But this I say, brethren, the time is short. It remaineth that both they that have wives be as though they had none.
That's right.
And they that weep as though they wept not.
Yeah.
And they that rejoice as though they rejoice not. Mm-hmm. And they that buy as though they possess not. And they that use this world as not abusing it.
Right.
For the fashion of this world passeth away.
Yeah.
Now, that was written more than 2,000 years ago, so how much more now? You know, we got seconds before Yahweh Shai comes and destroys the society. We really believe we're close. All the signs are there. You know, even Pastor said that.
Well, when you go into the prophecies, one prophecy that popped into my head was Daniel's second chapter.
That's
the feet of it.
Oh, yeah. Right.
So we're in that time.
We're in there. Mm-hmm. We're in there.
You got the head. Oh, it's cold.
We're in there.
I got a quick precept. This is our 1 Peter 1:9. Receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls, of which salvation the prophets have inquired and searched diligently, who prophesied of the grace that should come unto you, which is Yahweh Shai, searching what or what manner of time the spirit of Yahweh Shai, which was in them, did signify when it testified beforehand the sufferings of Yahweh Shai and the glory that should follow. So that's the hard part of the hastening. Because they were looking for the Messiah, because they knew once the Messiah came on the scene, then the kingdom would come. And this is why they thought that he said as he was walking, Yahweh said that they thought immediately the kingdom of heaven should appear. And that's why I said the kingdom of heaven is not coming with observation, for the kingdom of heaven is within you. But once Yahweh suffered, now we know the next step is what? The next phase is the kingdom of heaven. And that's what we're waiting for.
Well, when he comes back, that's what he's going to institute, the kingdom of heaven.
Yeah.
Which heaven is basically a state of mind, you know. Right now we're in Esau's hell. Esau's heaven is our hell, right? And in the kingdom, our heaven is going to be his hell.
Right.
Because that's in the parable of the rich man and Lazarus.
Hey, when you deal with a prophetic timetable, that's another topic.
Yeah,
throwing it out there. A prophetic timeline.
Yeah.
How do we know that we're in that time? Because when you go to Daniel 7, just as an example, you got the head of gold, you got the breast and the shoulders of silver.
Yeah,
you got the belly, which is
brass.
Was it brass?
Silver and brass.
Bronze, yep.
Your brass, yeah. And then you got a bronze. And then you got the legs of iron, which is the Romans.
Yep.
And then you got the
feet.
The feet of it,
mm-hmm.
part iron and part miry clay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What is that talking about?
Right.
Anybody that claims to know prophecy, If I tell you, what is that talking about? What is the feet talking about? You better tell me it's NATO and the EU. If you're telling me something else, you don't know nothing. Right. You don't know nothing.
We're at that time.
Yeah. So what's next to come?
Yeah.
The rock.
Yeah.
Just to break it into pieces.
Yeah. Well, to back up Pastor Dar, as you were saying, if you notice each metal was a more degenerative.
Inferior
than the next.
Stronger.
Yeah.
Physically, but as far as
quality.
Preciousness.
Preciousness, yeah. Inferior. You know? Yeah. Because it started out with gold, fine gold. Then it dwindled down to what? Just clay and iron.
Iron is like one of the strongest metals out there.
Which shows you Esau's kingdom.
And the cheater, yep.
And that proves something we always say Esau's kingdom is nothing compared to the kingdoms before it. Because right. The Babylonian kingdom, man, even though they didn't have all that so-called high technology, that was a powerful kingdom. You know, the Babylonian kingdom. That's why Daniel said to Nebuchadnezzar, thou art that head of gold. That symbolized his kingdom. He had that wonderful kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
But the Lord took that down. Then you had the.
And who did the Most High give the dream to? He gave the dream to Nebuchadnezzar.
Which
was a heathen. So that more proof. Right. The Most High gives dreams and visions to other nations.
Right. The Pharaoh, he gave the dream about the seven.
Yeah. Seven years of plenty and seven.
That's another. Yeah, man. So it's just the Lord's program, man.
I got a piece of it.
Well, he deals with both sides. You guys always forget that. The Heavenly Father said, Isaiah 45, I create peace and I create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things.
Yep.
So there's nothing that's, whether it be wickedness or righteousness, there's nothing that the Heavenly Father doesn't
do. Yeah, because what Yaakov did to Esau would be considered evil or wicked.
Right.
But guess what? The Most High said, left that.
He sanctioned it.
Ultimately, he's righteous.
Yeah. Even when he does wickedness, he's righteous. He's righteous in all his works, whether it be good or evil. A lot of you can't understand that. How can the power
vengeance is his? Save the Lord.
Yeah.
And say it, hey, like Richard Pryor said, the preacher, he said he say it anytime he get ready to say it.
Yeah, and then he said, would he then find fault? And the scripture say, well, who has resisted his will?
That's it.
You know, whether it be good or evil, you can't resist the will.
And this is what you churches don't understand.
Yeah.
The rape thing. That comes off as evil. It's evil, but
it's evil.
It's an evil ass.
Well,
it's a quick evil ass.
I got a quick precept.
And you guys can't get that, man. That's why I've been trying not to even say. You know, you guys just getting an uproar, man.
Yeah.
Hey, Barack, he kicked out of Elder Yaakov because he got with a chick that was 16 years old. He's like 56. He said, look, you gotta get out of here. You need to get an upload, man. You know how you get your smartphone.
Yeah.
The phone will work.
Oh, yeah.
You get them updates.
Yeah.
You need about 15 updates, man.
Yeah. Romans, what is
you
it?
Get
Romans,
back on level yeah. one.
On track.
Romans the 11th chapter. You think it's dealing with the heathens, the oil.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not the oil.
Yeah, talking about the other nations.
Yeah, the olive tree.
Oh, the engrafted.
Yeah, that was the grafted. Old. That's what Ariad taught. High priest Ariad. High priest Ariad was going off.
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys. I don't know if they went up there and told you. Ariad went off on certain things.
Yeah. Definitely. This is Isaiah 45:7. It says, "I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things."
Yeah, there was a question that some men kept asking to Captain Desariac. Does the Most High make a man a mole? He said, no, he don't. I said, yes, he does.
Exactly.
Romans 1 tell you that.
Yeah.
If a guy's a faggot, the Most High put his spirit on him to be a mole.
Yeah.
Gave him over to a reprobate mind.
And when you read the scripture, the word Lord is all in caps. So, now, they could have left it... capital, you know, the first letter capital and the rest lowercase, but all the letters are in caps. So you know who that's talking about? The Heavenly Father, Yahweh.
And then that's not spoken about in Genesis 1. It's spoken about in Genesis 2.
Yep.
Was it Genesis 2 verse 4? It says the Lord God. In Genesis 1:1, it says God. Mm-hmm. And you go to any church, they wouldn't let you. You can confound the churches just by going to those two scriptures.
Look at that.
You know?
Because I'm in the Hebrew now, and I'm looking at it. Yahweh. It says, for the Lord, it says Yahweh, which that's the Most High's name, Yahweh.
Yep.
And his son's name is Yahweh Shai. So he said he created a good and evil. All right, so there you go.
Yes.
I got a piece of it, if I may. This is 2 Esdras, the 6th chapter, and the 7th verse. Because the Most High deals with time, you know? And he sets up nations for a certain period of time, take them out, sets up another one. Except this time, he's going to set his kingdom up under Yahweh Shai that will rule, is the only kingdom that will rule forever and will not be taken down by no other nation. So this is 2 Esdras in the Apocrypha, chapter 6, verse 7. And it says, then answered I and said, what shall be the parting asunder of the times? Or when shall be the end of the first and the beginning of it that followeth? And he said unto me, from Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau, because these are the two characters of the movie that make up the movie. It's all about Jacob and Esau. Every other nation is like filling, you know?
Yeah, they're the two stars.
Right, these are the two stars. Everybody else is like extras.
The protagonist and the antagonist.
Yeah, it says, from Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau were born of him, Jacob healed of Esau, for Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. So you have to find out who is Esau in this world. We came to find out that the Edomites are these, well, the Romans. We found out as of late, Spirit was saying that, you know, coming out more.
But
that
Roman died and came back and was risen back up again.
Right. Because
See, once you understand this book,
right,
and once you listen to the men that the Most High set up, it's easy, man.
Right.
But you wanna try to
go deep.
Use your warped mind to try to figure this thing out.
Yeah.
This book is not given to, that's why we gotta go back to Second Ezra 14 chapter, because it said some give to the wise, others hold back. That's also in 2 Ezra 12 chapter, around about the 36, 37 verse.
Mm-hmm. And Daniel's
it says
also.
Some give to some, the one that's wise, and to the others, don't give them.
Yeah.
Right.
I got a quick precept. Daniel 2, 20 and 21. Daniel answered and said, blessed be the name of the Most High forever and ever, for wisdom and might are his, and he changeth the times and the seasons. He removeth kings and setteth up kings. He giveth wisdom. Now, this is Dennis.
I'm beautiful. Can I cut you off?
Yeah.
Trump just knew he was going to be president again. But the elite on this earth said nope.
Yeah.
And they probably was going to let him be president. The plan was to let him be president, but he was bucking up against too many things.
Right.
He said that. The first thing he said about the thing was it was a hoax.
Yeah.
That's the first thing he said. They didn't even want to wear the mask, and he said by April, he was bucking up against the leadership, man.
Because
that's Nero. That's Nero's nature.
Yep, right.
And then, see, the ultimate leader of the Roman Empire was not Nero or Vespasian. You had guys behind the scenes.
Yep.
You had the Illuminati behind the scenes, man.
Yep.
So they said, we're going to take a robot, and we're going to put him, an actual robot, and put him up in there. And now he made a statement. I heard it from somebody, I think it was Dabu 7. Or, oh, by the way, Dabu 7 is a Gadite. His line, he's a Hopi Indian.
Mm.
He said, he got about a figure. He's way
Jay. You know, he raps and everything. He raps, he dances.
Talk shit. It's like Jay. Anyway, I believe he said that. I could be wrong. Or somebody else said that. Tim, whatever. I don't know if you watch this guy. Tim something.
Tim Cass,
I think he said, one of them guys said that, which he's a Jake. That dude ain't nothing but a Jake. I think he's a white boy. But anyway, what did he say? Damn, I hate this. Oh, he said that one of them said that Biden said a while back, could have been 4 years ago, he made a statement. He said, if somebody want to look it up, they can look it up. He said, only a dictator
right
would make a whole bunch of executive orders.
Right.
Now, what did the first thing he did?
Executive
in two
order.
Weeks, he signed off on 40 different executive orders.
Right. He says,
so he prophesied against himself.
Yeah.
So he's telling you that he's a dictator.
Yeah, a tyrant, uses executive orders, or the executive orders are used by tyrants or something like that?
Or tyrants or dictators.
Dictators.
You looking it up?
Yeah.
I saw the thumbnail, but I didn't.
I heard it from somebody who saw it, something. You know, we get so much stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
So he was showing you in a roundabout, but these people, they don't know what's going on. And he was a guy that told Justice Roberts in the Senate, in the confirmation, when he was in the Senate in 05, he said, "You will rule on that before your tenure's over." Can you put a microscopic tag in a person's body?
Right.
"You will rule on that, mark my words."
Yeah, now they're denying it, because from here, CNN Politics, it says, fact check, no, Biden didn't say that signing lots of executive orders makes you a dictator.
Well, you know what? See, that's what they do.
Yeah,
that's what they do.
Yeah.
That's deplorable. What do you call it? The plausible. What do you call
plausible
it?
Denial.
Plausible. Plausible. It should be plausible.
Yeah.
Deplorability.
Deniability.
Deniability.
And it's dated Saturday, January, which is today, right? January 30th?
Yep. So you know why? Because people been talking. You know, there goes that QAnon again.
Yep.
There goes those conspiracy theories.
Mm-hmm.
Updated 6:48 a.m. Saturday, January 30th, 2021.
That's damage control.
That's all that is.
I got that, Buffalo.
Go ahead.
This is from CNN.
Just like they did the damage control with Kissinger saying military men are nothing but stupid animals used for policies, foreign policies or whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he never said that. He never said that. He was the one that came up with the term useless eaters, in a particular book he wrote.
Okay.
So come on now.
I got damage control. It says, an effort to minimize or curtail damage or loss.
Well, a perfect example recently was Johanna. Go ahead and get that thing. And you notice he ain't talking about it no more.
Right.
Because everybody, all of Jake's attacked him. He said, you know what, don't mention it ever again. Go ahead, what you got?
Yeah, this is from CNN Politics, Washington, CNN. President Joe Biden has signed more than 35 executive orders, actions, and memorandums in his first week and a half in the Oval Office.
Well, whether he said that or not, he is a dictator. Executive orders mean what? The president makes these orders, and then when he's out of office, the next president can reverse all those orders. That's when that's when you bypass Congress.
Right,
right.
Which is supposed to be the actual...
Everything is supposed to be done through Congress.
And that they speak about the president's dictatorial powers.
Yeah, because the laws don't come from the executive branch. It comes from...
They just execute the laws.
Yeah, it comes from the judicial.
No, it comes from the...
Legislative.
Legislative.
Legislative. Yeah. You have the executive, you have the judicial, you have the legislative.
That's it, right, brother? You got it right. You came back, you know? Slipping with the tongue. Congress is Article 1, then you got the Executive, Article 2, and then you got the Judicial, Article 3. Judicial interprets the laws.
Right.
If they challenge it, this law is unconstitutional, you go to the Supreme Court.
Right, so that's the dealing with the judges.
Judicial. No?
Then the legislative is...
It's Congress. It's in the Senate.
Make the law. First, it's a bill. Remember that old cartoon? I'm just a bill. See, they don't even do that.
And the president can veto the bill.
Right.
Yeah, that shows you.
Which is a form of executive
order.
Yeah.
Fiat, you know?
Yeah, back in the day, you had cartoons that actually enlightened you. Like that cartoon, I'm just a bill. If you brothers Google it on YouTube, you'll see it.
Right.
They would tell you.
Conjunction, what you
conjunction. You would actually learn something.
And now is a person, place, or thing.
Yeah.
Because today they use that word now is because they remember that cartoon.
Yeah. Yeah. But now, today, that's why this generation is just
dumbed down.
Dumbed down.
Which is part of the agenda.
I
still have, I'm trying to get to the point if I could. All right, it says, Biden signed off on a record.
Let me see. Salakia. So point is this. Okay. As recently as October, now President Biden said you can't legislate by executive action unless you're a dictator. That's the quote he made.
But that, but they're saying he never said that. Oh, I never said that. Oh, I never said that.
Plausible deniability. Mm-hmm.
All right, so let's go back. If we got the precept bringing out, let's go back. I want to go back to 2 Ezra 4, okay. 14.
Isaiah 10 and 1. Woe to them that decree unrighteous decrees and their right grievousness which they have prescribed, to turn aside the needy from judgment, and to take away the right from the poor of my people, that widows may be their prey, and that they may rob the fatherless.
Yeah, widows, that's talking about us Israelites. They pray. Why do you think they're pushing that Maxine? And the main people they want to take it is you tribes out there. So,
Yeah, one good thing about this guy with all these executive orders, now they're going to have that transgender thing. I think you're a woman, which is good for Jake men, because if they go to jail, just say, I'm a woman. You bring, I'm a woman. No, you, yes, I feel in my spirit, I'm a woman. But I'm stuck. I was born, and they got to put you in there with the woman. You go to the Supreme Court, yes, you can, if you think you're a woman, you go to, you niggas be waiting online to go to get locked up. Right. To get with the woman, you know? Because yeah, she's a woman too, that likes to rape other women.
Isn't that a prophecy where it says have become like women?
Yep. Nahum 3, and also somewhere in Jeremiah.
Either 50 or 51.
Yeah, but it said Nahum 3, 2.
Yep.
Yeah, they got this dude, it is, right? Isaiah 19 and 16. In that day, shall Egypt be like unto women. And the Egypt is talking about, Isaiah 19, the Egypt is talking about is America.
Yeah.
All right? America is spiritually known as Egypt. That's in Revelation.
Yeah.
In that day shall Egypt be like unto women, and it shall be afraid and fear because of the shaking of the hand of the Lord of hosts.
Yeah, because Moses literally shake this place up with the missiles.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Which he shaketh over it. So, man. And that's why I keep telling you, people out there, especially you brothers, when your Havashai comes, man.
Well, everybody's going to, it's going to stop the world. That anything is, that's happening, it could be, you could be in the middle of the NBA championships.
Yeah.
When the Lord comes, they fuck the championship. It could be Tyson making another comeback. They're going to get the hell with you, damn Tyson.
Yeah.
You know?
Was that movie, The Day the Earth Stood Still, when that robot came and just everybody just...
Yeah, clap to him. Platoon, name of the robot.
Yeah,
that was 1951, the day the Earth stood still. Which that's gonna happen when Yahweh shot. And then you know they made all those movies, where right after the appearance of all those so-called UFOs.
Yeah, they played off of that. Yeah.
You know? In Washington, no.
Washington D.C.
The UFO incident.
Yep.
You brothers out there, Google the UFO, the 1951 UFO incident. When D.C. was invaded by chariots, and Truman was president at that time. He was so scared, he ordered jets to be scrambled to go and fight the so-called UFOs. And when they got up there, the so-called UFOs just disappeared.
Yeah, they were gone.
Showing their power.
Yeah. So they've been known about,
And when that's Jeremiah 10 and 1 on down, people are dismayed at them. And when we see the ships, and we, Baraka, and I said in one video recently, I said, don't be surprised if you start hearing, there's so many UFO sightings, don't be surprised if you start hearing sounds coming out of here and voices and speaking in Hebrew.
Oh, horns blowing?
Horns blowing, yeah.
That would be dope, man.
Well, that already happened, I believe, in Israel a couple of years ago or somewhere. I believe it was Israel, when they heard this sound, they couldn't pinpoint where it was coming from.
Right.
And it sounded like a blowing trumpet,
Right. Check that out.
Mm-hmm. Well, they show you some of the movies. When they show the chariots, they show the horns.
Yep. Well, in that movie with Tom Cruise, they announced that they had the horns blown.
Yeah, the trumpets blown.
Yeah, right before they started.
It was just A Close Encounter of the Third Kind.
Oh, yeah.
They communicated with the ships with trumpets.
With trumpets.
You know?
Well, they know. And what we said that earlier, that these devils know. You know? I got...
And then that movie, was it the Close Encounter of the Third Kind?
Yeah.
The chosen people, that was that Devil Mountain in Wyoming, which is an actual mountain.
Right.
And it looks weird, you know?
Right.
And the spirit summoned them to that mountain. And they were all those people were all so-called Jews, because Dreyfus is a so-called Jew. The woman with the kid, they was all so-called Jews. Because they were saying that the ship was going to come down and deliver the Jews, but they got those were the wrong Jews. They're going to come and get the real Jews, right. You know, the Israelites.
It was that cosmic slot where they show you the Jakes going being brought up into the chariots. Was that that movie? Was that Cosmic Slop?
I don't know about that movie.
I know, what's his name?
Maybe I got
Parliament. They always talk about the so-called UFOs. Yeah, they did a song called Cosmic Slop. Okay. But George Clinton, he's always talking about the so-called. He did that one, Swing Down, Sweet Child, Let Me Ride.
Yeah.
He's talking about the mothership. He calls it the mothership. But it's actually the fathership.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so.
Fathership.
I got Jeremiah 10:1. It says, Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel. Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them.
Truman was the heathen. He got dismayed. He got shook up.
That's it.
I have a precept of him. This is the book of Haggai, chapter 2, verse 6. It says, for thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once it is a little while, and I will shake the heavens, and the earth, and the sea, and the dry land. Mm-hmm. He says a little while back then. Mm-hmm. That was about 2,500 years ago. So how closer are we now, you know?
And a pillow by day, and a cloud by day, and a pillar of fire by night,
mm-hmm.
was a gigantic... That ship had to be maybe 50 miles in diameter or more.
Damn.
Wow. Damn. I got a quick precept. Luke 21:25. And there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations with perplexity. The sea and the waves are roaring. Men's hearts failing them for fear, for looking after those things which are coming on the earth.
Yeah, the things coming on the earth are the angels of the Lord. With the angels, the missiles.
Oh, yeah. By the way, these words are in red, so Yahusha actually said this. Men's hearts failing them for fear and for looking after those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh.
Yeah, that's right.
And by the way, Yahusha was talking to his disciples, which are back here in reincarnation. So that's what we're looking for. When we see all these so-called UFOs cover the skies, like it says in Revelation 1, we know, man. we'll know what's happening.
Yep.
Now, the majority of people, they'll fuck out.
Yep.
So let's go back to what, Second Ezra. Come on. More into that. See what we can get out of that.
Second Ezra 14 and 16. For yet great evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done hereafter. For look how much the world shall be weaker through age.
Yeah.
So much the more shall evils increase upon them that dwell therein.
Or if I may say, the great evils, good examples is transgender.
Oh, yeah.
That was unheard of back then. But it's like common thing now.
Yep.
So that's
homosexuality.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's your great evils.
Pedophilia.
In a way, Trump was kind of righteous because when he got into office, pretty much Trump really wasn't all that bad.
Right.
You know?
Right.
You know, he was arrogant, but he reversed that executive order that Obama about gays in the military. He said, nah, you can't, you know? And then as soon as this guy came into office, he reversed that on executive order, you know?
Yep. That's why they got rid of Trump, like you were saying earlier.
Yeah, he was a maverick.
He was doing his own thing. Now, they could have did a JFK on him, but I guess for some reason they decided, we ain't going to do that, you know.
Go ahead.
It says, for the time has fled far away, and leasing is hard at hand. For now hasteth the vision to come, which thou hast seen. Then answered I before thee and said, behold, Lord, I will go as thou hast commanded me, and reprove the people which are present, but they Behold, Lord, I will go as thou hast commanded me.
He will go as what? As thou hast commanded me. Right. So you got a guy that says he's a prophet, but he just disappears for like 2 years.
The great Houdini.
And then he just kind of pops back up speaking Hebrew or whatever. You know what I'm saying? That's not a prophet. You're doing what you want to do, man.
Yeah.
Or like you hire
you. You want a mission. And like you have the people in the feds, the CIA.
Right.
The Queen's Secret Service or whatever, MI6 or whatever, they're giving an order. This is, you got to do this. That's your mission. Yeah. You can't do what the fuck you want to do, or you'll be labeled a spy, man, or a double agent. And the penalty of that is death.
Insubordination.
Why you think the Most High took my man out? Because he wasn't doing the will of the Most High.
Come free.
Yeah, also, Howard Godfrey said, the work is over.
Who taught him that?
Yeah,
where did
he
get that from?
Yeah, that's
because
he
said
the
harvest is the
end
of the world. Yeah, I
wish. Well, he never did the work. He never worked.
He never did the work anyway.
He was just a guy that hovered around, talking shit.
Yep.
Eating turkey legs and shit.
The dude almost had a heart attack when he found out that Moses leaving. He called me at my number. He said, "Dog, what you gonna do? What you gonna?" He was all nervous. What you gonna do, brother? I said, I'm going with the king. I'm down with the king. I'll tell you without batting the eye, man. I said, I'm going with Mo. He's the head man. Oh, but you sure? He didn't know where to go. Mm. You know? Big Negro didn't know where to go. He gonna call me. He gonna call little old me.
Oh, love it.
Go ahead.
Behold, Lord, I will go as thou hast commanded
me. What are them people going to do, the ICGs, AFC, what are they going to do when they actually make it mandatory to get the chip?
They're going to take it.
A lot of them going to take it.
Like I said, a lot of y'all are going to scramble. A lot of y'all are going to bug out.
Mm-hmm.
When the hour of temptation comes, you're going to bug the hell out. All together. You're going to bug out.
A lot of those people that follow ISUPK, they're going to take that chip.
Yeah, well, if I may read this, Isaiah 33 and 6.
Mm-hmm.
It says,
key word is stable.
Yeah. Isaiah 33 and 6, it says, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times.
Right.
And strength and salvation, the fear of the Lord is his treasure.
Yeah, like a stable that keeps all the horses in and keeps them protected, you know? So that stability, the knowledge is what keeps you stable from the hurt that's going to come upon the world.
That's right. Go ahead. Let's see where we at.
2 Ezra 14 and 20. Behold, Lord, I will go as thou hast commanded me and reprove the people which are present, but they shall be the day that shall be born afterward, who shall admonish them? Thus the world is set in darkness, and they that dwell therein are...
Hold up. Come back. Mm-hmm. You got to break that down. Come back.
But they that shall be born afterward, who shall admonish them?
That's talking about the next generation. When he dies and the new people, who? Yeah. The next crop of prophets.
Yeah.
Which are the same crop of prophets that were back there.
Right.
We keep coming back.
Yep.
The spirit of the prophet is subject unto the prophet. So now Ezra, is Ezra here now? He could be.
Come.
We don't know who he is.
I got a precept since you said that.
But if he's here among us, you know, when I say among us in this earth, he's teaching. He ain't working. He ain't operating a Amtrak train.
Yeah.
He ain't working at a gas station, you know? he ain't working 12 hours a day at Uber Eats.
No.
He's doing the work.
I got a quick precept to back you up. Isaiah 34 and 16, it says, seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read.
Yep.
No one of these shall fail, none shall want her mate. For my mouth hath commanded.
Why none shall want her mate? Mm. Why no other book can mate with this book?
Because the, these
because of the prophecies.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This is the only book, and like I did in this previous video I did, I say, if you go to any version of the Bible, it could be the NIV, it could be the New American Standard, or whatever the New King James,
New Living Translation,
the New Living Translation, the Jehovah Witness Green Book, mm-hmm. the Geneva,
right.
You know, all of them say the same thing in Revelation 13. Says the same thing.
Yep.
Says the same thing. So if you don't got the King James, you got another book. It's going to, another version of the Bible. It's going to say the same thing. Written a little bit differently.
Right. Yep. Isaiah 34 and 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. No one of these shall fail. None shall
fail. No one of these shall fail. There's none of the prophecies shall fail.
Yeah.
And this is what High Priest Ariah told me years ago now.
Right.
High Priest Ariah did go into the breakdown of the mark of the beast. And you know what he said it was? He said it was for it to be in your right hand, that means you take the gun up for the white man. Or if it's in your head, that means you think the way the white man thinks. You know, you believe in Caesar Borgia.
Yeah.
And so, but I knew that it wasn't talking about that, and I pulled him to the side, just me and him. And I said, could the mark of the beast be an actual stamp that they put in you? And you know what he said? He said, yeah. He said, but they're not going to have time to do it. But wait a minute. Then that means that the Most High is a liar.
Right.
The Most High put up prophecies, but,
yeah.
You know, he landed back on his prophecy. No. The Most High said it, and it's got to come to pass. I mean, there's many precepts on that.
His word don't go out void.
His word don't go out void. So if he said there's going to be a the mark of the beast, you know?
Yeah.
So did Ariah say that the mark of the beast is a microchip? You damn right he said it. But he said something that he went off on. But they're not going to have enough time to do it, which clearly makes, you know?
No sense.
Yeah.
Yep. Back in Isaiah 34 and 16.
And when you go, 34 and 16, you got to keep reading that.
Yeah.
Because it says that some got this amount of prophecy, others got that amount of prophecy.
Yeah.
You got major prophets, Jeremiah, Isaiah, Ezekiel. Then you got minor prophets, Obadiah, Joel, which Esau calls them that. Go ahead, Go ahead.
Isaiah 34 and 16, it says, seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read, no one of these shall fail, none shall want her mate, for my mouth it hath commanded.
So if the Lord commanded it, didn't he command that there's going to be a mark of the beast?
Yeah.
Well, how is the prophecy going to be upset?
Right.
How is the missiles going to upset the prophecies of the mark of the beast?
Right.
It's impossible. Everything's got to happen pursuant to how the Most High said it and in his order.
Yeah. For my mouth it hath commanded, and his spirit it hath gathered them.
Hold up. What is his spirit? The Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
The Comforter.
Yeah.
The spirit that comes with the scriptures.
Yeah. Yeah, there's an actual spirit that comes with the scriptures. That's the Holy Spirit.
Which is the Comforter.
Comforted. And he hath cast a lot for them, and his hand hath divided it unto them by line.
Yes, some prophets got more than others.
Right.
As far as prophecy is concerned.
They shall possess it forever.
Are we here? We're 2,000 years later.
Yeah.
2,500 years later. 3,000 years later.
Still here.
3,500 years later, we still be possessing it in the form of the book.
Yep. And that destroys that old wives' tale. He used to teach at the school. When we went into captivity, Cornelius is a white man that held it.
Yeah, because they didn't, the Most High didn't open up their eyes to that particular
right.
breakdown, understanding, hermeneutics.
Right.
Hermeneutics.
17th verse, and he hath cast the lot for them, and his hand hath divided it unto them by line.
And them are the prophets.
Right. They shall possess it forever. From generation to generation shall they dwell therein. And I remember what Elder Apostle Ramnab read. It was Esdras, he asked, what's going to happen to the next generation? Who's going to warn them? Like Elder Apostle Tar said, in that generation, the Lord's going to raise up a crop of prophets to warn them.
Yeah. And so to say that the prophets have been here from the beginning.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's what the prophets do. one of the things they do is warn the Lord's people. That, as a matter of fact, I'll give that.
Yeah, you know how I used to go back in the days about Adam hearing the voice of the Lord in the cool of the day. You know, that was the prophets back then in the beginning. You know, pretty much the Most High was kind of probing him and asking him through the prophets. Like, what did you do, Adam?
Yeah, it is right here. Ezekiel 3:17. And what was Ezekiel? He was a prophet. And it came to pass at the end of seven days that the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me. So that, you know, that's what the prophets did. They warned the Lord's people.
So who are these guys that be taking 3 years off? Two years off, 5 years off.
They're false prophets.
Yeah, they're just Israelites. Just Israelites.
Because you got your true prophets, but you also got your false prophets too. And the Heavenly Father controls both of them. There's a scripture where it says, if a prophet speak a thing that doesn't happen, I, the Lord, have deceived that prophet. So you got your true prophets and you got your false prophets.
Yep.
So come on, let's read on.
All right, so back in 2 Ezra 14 and middle of 20. Mm-hmm. But they that shall be born afterward, who shall admonish them? Thus the world is set in darkness, and they that dwell therein are without light. For the law is burnt. Therefore no man knoweth the things that are done of thee, or the work that shall begin. But if I have found grace before thee, send the Holy Spirit into me.
Is that not the apocrypha? So the comfort is mentioned in the Apocrypha. Mm-hmm. What does it mean by send the Holy Spirit to me?
Right.
It means it can be the comfort.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know?
That understanding so I could, you know.
So is that Tazadakya?
Oh no. Mm-hmm. Oh no, no.
They were on a low level. After the name breakdown went, one west went on a low level, man. Mm-hmm. Because if I was back there, that shit wasn't happening, man.
No.
Me and my big mouth.
And I shall write all that had been done in the world since the beginning.
Prophecies. Go ahead.
Which were written in thy law, that men may find thy path, and that they which will live in the latter days may live.
The latter days are now. May live. So the prophets are here all over again.
Yeah, Apostle Paul said he lived by the grace of Yahweh Shaddai. That is within him. He said the rest of his time, he said he lived by Yahweh Shaddai. Keeps him alive. Yep. And that's the story for us. We're living basically by the spirit of Yahweh Shaddai. Yeah. The spirit of Yahweh Shaddai. Because his life is within us.
Yeah.
If not, man, I know personally, me speaking, I've been dead a long time ago. Because, you know, we're not of this world. You know, we're in the world, but we're not of this world, brothers. You know, we're like that square peg in the round hole. We just don't fit in. Nowhere, anywhere we go, we just don't fit in. Because this ain't our world.
Says, and he answered me, saying, go thy way, gather the people together, and say unto them that they seek thee not for 40 days. But look, thou prepare. And that's the same amount of time that the Most High held Moses. But look, thou prepare thee many box trees.
Which means Ezra's would have had to been Moses in his past generation.
Well, we don't know that. Just leave it.
Speculation.
Yeah, just leave it. Like I said, we don't know who the prophet. We have some ideas.
Right.
You know?
Okay.
But look, thou prepare thee many box trees, and take with thee Saria, Debria, Salamia, Ikanus, and Aziel, these five which are ready to write swiftly.
So that meant that the Most High set these guys up. Yep. They didn't just pop up. Right. You know, I'm going to be the guy that writes.
Right.
No, the Most High chose these guys and put the spirit on them. Right. And they said when they're going to write these prophecies, they're going to, because it's going, the spirit's going to be on them.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep. Like, you know, they have that thing called shorthand. When people dictate and, you know, you
know. Yep.
So that's a skill.
That's a skill, yep.
It says, and come hither, and I shall light a candle of understanding in thy heart, which shall not be put out till the things be performed which thou shalt begin to write. You know? It says that when thou hast done, some things shalt thou publish, and some things shalt thou show secretly to the wise. Tomorrow this hour shalt thou begin to write. Then went I forth as he commanded, and gathered all the people together, and said, Hear these words, O Israel. Our fathers at the beginning were strangers in Egypt, from whence they were delivered, and received the law of life, which they kept not, which ye also have transgressed after them. Then was the land, even the land of Zion, parted among you by lot. But your fathers and ye yourselves have done unrighteousness, and have not kept the ways which the highest commanded you. And for as much as he is righteous, he is a righteous judge, he took from you in time the thing that he had given you, and now are ye here and your brethren among you. Therefore, if so be that you will subdue your own understanding and reform your hearts, you shall be kept alive, and after death you shall obtain mercy. For after death shall the judgment come, when we shall live again. And then shall the names of the righteous be manifest, and the works of the ungodly shall be declared.
We're in that time now.
Mm.
They declared that this man is a devil.
Yep. Oh, that lines up with what the Apostle Paul said, that man of sin
be revealed. Yep.
Yeah.
Let no man therefore come unto me now, nor seek after me these 40 days. So I took the five men, as he commanded me, and we went into the field and remained there. And the next day, behold, a voice called me, saying, Ezra, open thy mouth, and drink that I give thee to drink. Then opened I my mouth, and behold, he reached me a full cup, which was full as it were with water, but the color of it was like fire. And I took it and drank. And when I had drunk of it, my heart uttered understanding. And wisdom grew in my breast, for my spirit strengthened my memory. That's heavy.
Yeah, if I may say that, water and that fire is really symbolic of the word, the Bible. Because
the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, the Holy Spirit.
Acts 2.
Because it said the cloven tongue were a fire.
Well, this is a fire. That's it.
Yeah, I got a quick precept, Jeremiah 5:14. Yeah, Jeremiah 5:14, it says, Wherefore thus saith the Lord, the power of hosts, because ye speak this word, behold, I will make my words in thy mouth fire, and this people wood, and it shall devour them. And then there's a scripture where Yahushua spoke about the living water when he was at the well with the Samaritan woman. He spoke about the living water, and then he called himself. He said, I am the living water.
Right.
If you drink of this water, you'll never thirst again. So water and fire, that's really, that's
scripture. It was a cleansing agent.
Out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. So that means that, and that goes hand in hand with Amos, the Lord has spoken, who can but prophesy. So this, a guy that claims he's a prophet, he's a man of the Lord, but he disappeared for 2 years, he's not a prophet. Because if he goes on that trip with his girl to Las Vegas, he'll start prophesying in the casino.
Right.
This place won't be destroyed. And she goes, what's wrong with you, nigga?
I thought we talked about this.
No more in old Israel in 2 weeks.
Yeah.
While we're in Las Vegas.
I got another quick precept. Isaiah 44.
They just go somewhere for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years.
Yeah. It's nothing.
And then they just come back like they never left.
Yeah.
What kind of bullshit is that?
Amazing.
That's
out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
Hey, Jeremiah said he couldn't hold the words of the Lord in.
It's just like vomiting. You can't help. You got to vomit.
You
be trying to not hit the toilet, but you might hit part of the floor. That's how you're supposed to, supposed to come out.
Let it all hang out.
Isaiah 44.
Everybody probably said, get some man over there.
Like that nigga with the pistol. Isaiah 44:2. Thus saith the Lord that made thee.
And when you got a vomit and you're in the bed, you run. You get out of the bathroom. You miss the toilet.
Because that shit sticks, all, man. Yeah. It smells and it sticks.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You ain't getting it. It's got to come out. Yeah, and it's involuntary.
Yeah, that's why you... I was going to say, you cats doing the Uber. You get a person looking like they want to walk. You know, they had the vomit.
Oh, well, I never had experienced that, but if somebody did do that,
man,
I'm going to get a workout.
Gonna make him lick that.
And then Uber, they were giving vomit bags. They had something called vomit bags. Anyway, Isaiah 44:2, thus saith the Lord that made thee and formed thee from the womb, which will help thee. Fear not, O Jacob, my servant, and thou Jeshurun, whom I have chosen. For I will pour water upon him that is thirsty, and floods upon the dry ground. I will pour my spirit upon thy seed and my blessing upon thy offspring. And they shall spring up as among the grass and as willows by the water courses. Another precept dealing with water.
Yeah. I have a precept to follow.
It's knowledge being important.
Oh, where's that? And let's speak about the cisterns.
Jeremiah.
Give me that. Give me that.
I get it. Broken cisterns. Jeremiah 2:13.
Jeremiah. Because we were in it earlier.
Jeremiah.
You want me to start with 11?
Start 11, yeah.
Jeremiah 2:11. Have a nation changed their gods, which are yet no gods, but my people have changed their glory for that which doth not profit him. Be astonished, O ye heavens, at this, and be horribly afraid. Be ye very desolate, saith the Lord. For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters, and hewed them out cisterns, broken cisterns that can hold no water.
Comedic Christianity.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Islam.
Yeah.
Democrat. You know.
Even within the truth.
Military. Yeah. Even within the truth. Yeah.
For Christ, you're coming in the name of Christ. Yeah. That's a broken cistern.
Yep. Christianity.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep.
That's why
dirty water.
That's why, like El Apostol says, we say too, IUIC, you're not going to last. That's a broken cistern. We're telling you like it is. ISUPK, another broken cistern. It ain't holding no water. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yep.
That's all it is.
Go ahead.
I got a precept.
Is there more to that? That was it?
It goes into Israel the servant.
Okay.
Yeah, I got a precept if I may. This is Matthew's, the third chapter in the 11th verse. This is St. John the Baptist. It says, I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance, but he that cometh after me is mightier than I.
What does it say in the 8th verse?
8th verse, bring forth therefore fruits meet for repentance.
No, you got to go up a couple more verses.
Okay. It says, I'll start the first verse.
See, there's certain people that you can identify that they ain't right. You know, when they roll up and you can kind of, hey, guy, come on the common board. And sometimes you get confused. The guy might be saying something right, but he comes off wrong. What's wrong?
Okay, I'm going to start the first verse and read fast. This is Matthew 3:1. It says, in those days came John the Baptist preaching in the wilderness of Judea and saying, repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
Why did he do that? Because the Most High set him up to do it, right?
He's
a
prophet.
So my question is, when did he go off? When did he fell out the truth?
Yeah, like
they'll show you that them guys don't have the truth. They fell out the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Forget about John. Yachanan.
Yeah.
He didn't fall out the truth. Johanna fall out the truth. Go ahead.
Okay. And saying, repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Verse 3. For this is he that was spoken of by the prophet Isaiah, saying.
Hold on. He's a fulfillment of what the prophet Isaiah said. Who is he? How is he going to come?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. How the hell is he going to go off?
How the hell is he going to go? But he went off. Wow.
Yeah, just
you got to say it like that. Wow. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah. Just like the Apostle Paul said, for the time will come when they will not endure
sound doctrine. That's right.
that's you guys, man.
Mm-hmm.
Teachers have
it. Oh, I'm about to say that. Yeah.
Go ahead.
It says, for this is he that was spoken of by the prophet Isaiah, saying, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make his paths straight.
But then he went off after he did that. After he prepared
the way. No, but when did he go off? He said, the Father was Christ. Let's see, he went off. He fell out the truth.
And then the same guy said, if I say John the Baptist is this bottle of scotch.
Yeah, that's crazy, man.
Pass me a shot.
At that moment, man, at that moment, you guys.
But see, a lot of you guys that come to Israel, you go in these different camps, you don't know what's going on.
Yeah. Each other's to and fro.
Yep.
Yeah, how are you going to sit there and listen to that?
Yeah, that was Babylon, crazy.
That was psycho babble.
Babylon moron.
Yeah, that was psycho babble.
Go ahead.
Verse 4. And the same John had his raiment of camel's hair and a leathern girdle about his loins, and his meat was locusts and wild honey. Then went out to him Jerusalem and all Judea and all the region round about Jordan, and were baptized of him in Jordan, confessing their sins. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and Sadducees come to his baptism, he said unto them, O generation of vipers, who have warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bring forth therefore fruits meet for repentance.
So they obviously wasn't meet good for repentance.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I got a quick precept.
When they were Israelites, how come we didn't say let's have a unity camp?
Right.
Yeah, John never had it. Another time. Mm-hmm. John never had a unity camp.
Right.
Sirach 19 and 29. A man may be known by his look, and one that have understanding by his countenance when thou meetest him.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess when John said, looked at their countenance, he said, oh, no.
He was in the spirit.
He was in the spirit, yeah.
All right, Matthew 3 and 8. Bring forth therefore fruits meet for repentance, and think not to say within yourselves, we have Abraham to our father. And think not to say within yourselves, we have Abraham to our father, for I say unto you that the Most High, Yahweh, is able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham.
I got another quick precept.
Mm-hmm.
Ezekiel 2 and 6. And thou, son of man, be not afraid of them, neither be afraid of their words, though briars and thorns be with thee, and thou dost dwell among scorpions. Be not afraid of their words, nor be dismayed at their looks, though they be a rebellious house. That's the same people that that you're reading about with John the Baptist. Those same people, same individuals. You know, Ezekiel 2 and 6. Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Matthew 3 and 10. It says, and now also the axe is laid unto the root of the trees.
Yeah.
Therefore, every tree which bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire.
That's comfy.
I was just thinking that, dude.
He got hewn down, and the next thing he's going to be cast into the fire because them spirits are going to be raised back up to be hit by a missile.
Right.
Ain't that something?
That's Daniel's 12th.
That's in Revelation as well.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to be raised back up to be hit with the missiles again.
Yeah.
So Matthew,
they're going to get double dipped.
Mm-hmm. Some to everlasting life.
So and shame and
everlasting contempt. Yeah. This is Matthew 3 and 11. It says, I indeed baptize you, because this is going back to what Apostle Gabor brought up. It says, I indeed baptize you with water unto repentance, but he that cometh after me is mightier than I, whose shoes I am not worthy to bear. He shall baptize you with the Holy Spirit, which is the Ruach HaKodesh, and with fire, whose fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly purge his floor and gather his wheat unto the garner. But he will burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. So his floor is, you know, the elect. And if there's wicked amongst the elect, the Most High is going to
purge it out.
Purge them out, and then ultimately burn their asses up.
Bind them in bundles and burn them. Mm-hmm.
That was it.
Okay, what we got? What we got?
Back in 2 Ezra 14 and 41. And my mouth was open and shut no more. The highest gave understanding unto the five men, and they wrote the wonderful visions of the night that were told, which they knew not. And they sat 40 days, and they wrote in the day, and at night they ate bread. As for me, I spake in the day, and I held not my tongue by night. In 40 days they wrote 204 books. And it came to pass when the 40 days were filled that the highest spake, saying.
And we don't have those books. Gone. We don't have those books, so there's more books. Gone. Now, a nigga could pop up and say that he got them books, and how many Jake can follow him?
Mm-hmm. A lot.
Whole mess of
them. Simple believeth every
word. Simple believeth every word.
It says, the first that thou hast written, publish openly, that the worthy and unworthy may read it. But keep the 70 last that thou...
Oh, the worthy and unworthy.
Yep.
So the worthy is going to understand it. The unworthy, they'll be lost. They won't understand it.
The wicked shall not understand
it. That's why some men is trying to get it.
Yeah.
He's unworthy. He can clearly see that the market abuses the chip. But he'll go to Captain Cesaro, who the captain? No, I ain't talking about that. GMS is going off.
Yeah.
Oh, that's why he wanted to have an interview with me.
Yeah.
Because he knows that we teach that. So he wanted to hear it from the horse's mouth, so to speak. As Lord Abraham said, you have Moses and the prophets. Well, my saying that you have the video.
Yeah.
Go check out the video.
Check out the video.
Check out the video. Go ahead.
It says, but keep the 70 last, that thou mayest deliver them only to such as be wise among the people. For in them is the spring of understanding, the fountain of wisdom, and the stream of knowledge. And
the stream of knowledge. The stream of knowledge. A stream doesn't, when a stream stops, you see a stream, a river, and it stops. Don't touch that stagnant water.
No.
And we when we make the videos, it's streamed. Mm-hmm.
The live stream.
The live stream. Mm-hmm. It's being streamed right now.
Yeah.
So this is water.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's a system right there. That,
yep.
So that you got a system.
Yeah.
Because stream, because something streams through it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yep. It's water pours out.
It's ongoing. It's ongoing.
Living water.
Even Bruce Lee said that.
Yep.
You'll be like water, my friend.
Yeah. It says, and I did so. And that's it. That's
I have a precept, if I may.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Daughter. This is Daniel's, the 12th chapter, in the 9th verse. And it says, and he said, go thy way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed to the time of the end.
Which were in the time of the end. Which were in the time of the end.
Certain of those words are still sealed. Like you guys talking about the mark of the beast is sleeping. A white woman or any crazy doctrine, that means that those words are sealed to you.
Right.
You know, those words are sealed to you. You don't understand it.
Hey, it's good to say, harden not your hearts as in a provocation.
Yeah. And the name, we don't have the name of the Heavenly Father, nor His Son. Those words are sealed to you. You go into prophecy, it says in the land of Egypt, we're going to be five cities, roughly paraphrasing it. Speaking what? The language of Canaan.
Which is Hebrew.
Which is Hebrew.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things we're going to speak is the name of the Father and the Son, which can only be uttered in Hebrew. Yeah. True names.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to listen to a guy tell you we don't have the name, we don't get those in the kingdom. He's calling the Heavenly Father a liar. Because the prophecy says in that land of Egypt, which is America, five cities are going to be speaking the language of Canaan, which is Hebrew. And when we came into the school, Hebrew was mandatory. You had to learn Hebrew at school at One West.
And that's a great thing, because that's why we're able to use a blue letter.
Oh, yeah.
We'll look at a certain word and we'll click on it.
Oh, yeah.
The Hebrew word is this, or the Greek word is that.
Yep. That was mandatory. You had to, first of all, you had the soldier's test, all right? You had the officer of 50, the officer of 100. Each test had, the soldier's test had the Hebrew. The officer of 50 had the Hebrew, the officer of 100 was a, what do you call it, a multi-choice answer. But the point I'm making is the first test, you had to know the Hebrew, because part of the test had Hebrew on it. That's how we came up. So we got introduced to the Hebrew, you know? And you got other Israelite groups, they, you know, have a lazy attitude towards the Hebrew.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of GMS, remember we used to put up Hebrew videos?
Yeah.
You get no views.
How are you going to be?
You put a new moon video up, you get no views.
Yeah.
Very little views on it.
Yeah, I just mostly watch the controversial stuff.
Yeah.
That's what Jake likes, man. Yeah. And when a lot of these camps, these young bucks coming up, they'll put the titles.
Yeah.
Muslim gets bludgeoned to death.
Yeah, yeah.
Shot fired and all that. Then you jump on it. It's clickbait, man.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Cause all you're doing is calling to yourself people that are not worthy.
Right. That's true. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the word doesn't need gimmicks.
And the world to come is for few. This world is for many. The world to come is for few.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep. Most ain't saving the masses of our people.
Yeah, that's right. Well, wait a minute, I'm right there. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you said, Apostle, because Romans 11 and 7. What then, Israel have not obtained that which he seeketh for,
mm-hmm.
but the election have obtained it.
And the rest were blinded.
Mm-hmm. Great Millstone, we're the only real Israelite group that keeps speaking about the elect,
yep.
the elect. That's like a part of the broken record, like the chip.
Mm-hmm.
Another broken record of ours is the elect. That's
mm-hmm.
the elect.
The missiles.
But
it's like they're afraid of because yep. they know they're gonna get burnt up.
Yeah, these other Israelite groups are telling you, you know, anybody could raise up the nation. No, the Lord is dealing with the.
That's elect. Not scriptural. The Lord's not raising up the whole nation. And
that's
our
it.
Job is not to, we are to go among all Israel.
Right.
But the Most High is going to pinpoint who the elect is in those masses, man.
Yeah.
You know, this gospel shall be preached throughout the whole world and then shall the end come. Through what? Through the web.
Mm-hmm.
All right, God did. You really got the truth because you got it on. No. Come on now.
Stop it.
Yeah,
anyway, we got any more precepts to get ready to...
Yeah, because I had... well, since you said that about the elect, this is Revelation
mm-hmm.
chapter 7, verse beginning at 1.
Oh, yeah.
And it says, "And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea."
Yeah, if I may say, the
mm-hmm.
wind is talking about the nuclear destruction. You know, a precept that lines up with that is Jeremiah 50 and also 51, where the Lord speaks about a destroying wind.
Yeah.
If you watch the movie Terminator 2, you see the scene with Sarah Connor, the chick who played Sarah Connor.
Yeah.
And you see her on the fence and you see the wall of fire.
Mm-hmm.
That's that destroying wind. Okay?
So Jeremiah 50 and Jeremiah 51 are two of my favorite chapters, man.
Oh, yeah.
And that's talking about the new Babylon, America.
Yep.
That's what the Lord, and there's another precept. The Lord say he will sweep this place
with the
besom of destruction.
Right.
Yep.
And you see that in the movie, you see the wall of fire sweeping across the land. That's how this place is going to be taken out. And it's going to hit every inch and every corner of this place. Right across.
Go ahead.
It says, "And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind shall not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree."
And those four angels are there right now.
Yeah.
Great River Euphrates and Revelation 16 and also Revelation 9, the ninth chapter. So that pilot cave is going to come out of the Great Levant, out of the Fertile Crescent,
mm-hmm.
near the Middle East.
Yeah, which makes sense because that's where the Most High started everything.
Yeah.
So that's where it shall end and then begin again. You know?
Full circle.
Yep. The Most High does things like that. Verse 2, it says, "And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living power.
And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our power in their flesh. Right. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And all this you got a Sakari talking about Dan. You know, Dan is these people. We don't know. You know what? It could be that Dan is mingled among them, but they're not being, they're not being identified as Dan. So when the Lord didn't mention Dan, Dan could be. You can have a guy as a Danite, but you can't say, well, he's a Danite.
Right.
You know?
Mm-hmm. It's like we're all Dan.
Yeah, well, Dan is mingled among
right.
us, man.
Right. You know?
Dan means judge.
So we'll find out what Dan is all about in the kingdom.
Right.
Yeah.
And the Most High is not going to set up the tribe of Dan in the kingdom. The tribe of Dan will have to be mingled among the other tribes. Mm-hmm. But that's we can't say anything more than that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And one brother asked me a question. I forget what he asked me. And how did I answer it? I forget his question, but I gave him a simple answer. He said, what is it? Oh, he said the sundial that the day went back, I think it was 10 minutes. He said, what is that all about? And I think I put down it's what it says it is. What else can I say?
Mm-hmm.
He came back and said, the water. What am I gonna say? Do a whole class?
Mm-hmm.
See when you go into the molecular, you know?
Yeah,
that's what these people want, man.
Yeah.
Some things are just simple. It's the most, you gotta get with the Most High.
Yeah.
Right.
You know?
Break out that.
Go get a rocket ship, you know, go to Virgin Atlantic and go up into space and see if you can meet one of the angels.
They bring a camera. Take notes.
Besides that, how does that help you with salvation?
Exactly. That's
well, you know how, you know, Jake, you know, he didn't mean wrong, but, you know, Jake, he wants to get deeper. Some things, there's no, you know, just that.
Yeah.
There's nothing I can say.
Yeah, that's why the Apostle Paul said things concerning salvation. Because you had those characters back then, too. You know, when it gets super deep. But the main thing you brothers should ask, especially you new to the faith, is things pertaining to salvation.
Yeah.
How can I be delivered from coming destruction?
Yeah. Saint Paul said, it's like Saint Paul said, all things are lawful, but all things are not exceeding.
Yeah. You know, you want to know the weight of a flame and
see
Esau knows the weight of a flame.
Mm-hmm.
They can see the image of a voice. Right. Esau can do all those things.
Yeah.
That's funny because we started the lesson saying that. You say that now we ended it
full circle. Full circle. That's how the Lord do full circle. I got a little more in Daniel 12. This is Daniel 12 and 10. It says, many shall be purified and made white and tried, but the wicked shall do wickedly, and none of the wicked shall understand, but the wise shall understand.
Yeah, which are the elect of Israel.
Mm-hmm. It says, and from the time that, like, we understand the chip, but the wicked of Israel don't. They can't, you know.
And wicked goes to the Israelites. Too.
Yeah.
They're wicked.
Yeah. Here is the mind that has wisdom.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It says, but the wise shall understand, and from the time that the daily sacrifice, shall be taken away, and the abomination that maketh desolate set up, there shall be 1290 days.
And you know what that's talking about? That's talking about 70 AD, the time period.
Mm.
And that number of days is talking about the time when Titus took Israel down. It was about three years. Three and a half years.
So then the next part of it is when, because after that, it was over. You know, there was no more persecution against Israel anymore.
Yeah, they were scattered.
Yep.
They were scattered. Yep.
This is verse 12. It says, blessed is he that waiteth and cometh to the 1300 and blessed is he that waiteth and cometh to the 1305 and 30 days.
Yeah, because those days were cut short. Because they fled.
Yep.
They got out of there. A lot of them were killed off.
Yep.
And others fled because they heard what Yahushua said. He told them that when the abomination that maketh desolate is talking about Titus, Vespasian, you know.
Flee into the mountains.
Verse 13, it says, but go thy way till the end be, for thou shalt rest and stand in thy lot at the end of the days.
So most likely Daniel's here. Mm-hmm. Among us.
Come, the Lord says something.
What does that mean, Volcan?
Mm-hmm. Oh, shit. He don't know.
He don't know.
He rolled up on Barack. Barack could have been Daniel.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, well, since Pastor Todd said that, Yahushua said, and I think you did a video on that, Apostle. Yahushua said, it's better a millstone, if you offend these little ones, better a millstone you put around your neck.
Correct.
You'd be, you read that drowned video you did. You'd be drowned in the deepest part of the sea, something like that. Rough
because you don't know you can look at a guy and see that he's a demon.
Yep.
And then you can look at a guy,
Yeah.
I don't know, brother.
Spirit's
working with it.
Yeah.
You can see through the spirit. Anyway, with that, I'm going to say shalom.
Shalom to the left.
And we hope y'all learn
to think it too.
It's like
a buzzer. You might have a water. That's spicy.